Check one, check one, check two. Can you hear me? Hello, hello, hello out there. Check. Thank you. Good evening, Sim fans. Welcome to the Thursday night live stream with your host, Sim Fanatic, and all of you Sim fans. Thank you for joining me yet once again for a Thursday night live stream here in X-Plane tonight, flying from the Nimbus scenery of Chicago O'Hare. We'll take a quick cruise through here. So welcome. And do appreciate all of you being with me tonight. So, let's go ahead and get started, Sim fans. I got an exciting thing that arrived today, and I think you probably saw it in the picture there. I got the Airbus throttle pack from Honeycomb that I pre-ordered. It came today. I was super excited. I got an alert, I think it was yesterday, on my phone that, hey, it's shipped. And I thought, okay, is this leaving Hong Kong today? So I wasn't really anticipating getting it for another week or so. And then the doorbell rang, and Sim fans, there it was. So then later on in the stream, we'll be doing a live unboxing of that. And we might go ahead and zoom in on the Honeycomb Bravo Throttle Quadrant, and we'll check those bad boys out. We'll see what that's all about. So yeah, tonight our flight, Sim fans, we will be going from here in O'Hare to Albuquerque, which is something that's by SimFinal, and it is definitely good payware as well. It's an old payware package. I've had it for several years, but definitely worth checking out with all of you. All right, let's turn those tunes down and let's get started, Sim fans. All right. How's everybody tonight? Hopefully everybody's doing well. Welcome. So we got our ground service vehicles. We're fueling up the airplane, loading up the baggage. And so it looks like they finished up there or haven't even opened the doors yet. So let's jump in. So one of the things, I had this whole thing we'll see how tonight goes. I had the aircraft, the FMC, everything preloaded. Let me turn the music off. Sorry about that. I've been having some issues tonight. I had Streamlabs crash on me, I had OBS crash on me, and then I had X-Plane crash on me. And of course, I get ready, and it's like 13 minutes till I've got everything programmed, everything ready to go. And I look and I'm like, where the hell is X-Plane at? And it just crashed the desktop. So anyway, so I scrambled to get everything loaded back up. So I'm not quite as far, but I've got the FMC programmed. Captain Maddie, how are you doing? Welcome to the stream, my friend. Welcome. Glad to have you here, Captain Maddie. So I had to scramble to get everything. So I'm pretty much ready for the APU startup like usual, but I was hoping to like get a little farther, like ready for pushback for all of you, so you don't have to wait for me to dink around and flip the switches and all that. But anyway, I didn't get through that yet, so we're going to pre-flight it. But does anybody want to take a look at the Nimbus scenery or just move on? Should we just get going or would you like to check it out? If I don't hear differently from all of you in chat, we'll just we'll take a quick look at the scenery here. So let's go to our free camera. Rojo, good evening. Welcome, Rojo, to the stream, my friend. Welcome. Glad to have you here, my friend. All right, so this is Rojo. This is the scenery from Nimbus. Oh my gosh, Aviation Spotter. Thank you, sir, for the $1 dono, my friend. Welcome, Aviation Spotter. Hope you are doing well, Aviation Spotter says. Thank you, Aviation Spotter. I am doing well, my friend. Thank you so much. Hopefully you are doing well as well. Not to be redundant. And all of you Sim fans. Aviation Spotter, welcome to the stream. Glad to have you here, my friend, as all of you. All right. Get moving, Captain Maddie says. So you know, you got the people walking around as scripted route here. But really quick, Captain Maddie, let's just go ahead and take a quick look since I'm already like in progress here. But I think it's a pretty good job. It's well done. There's one thing to note: if you have X-Plane and you get the Nimbus scenery, do follow the instructions. Otherwise, you aren't going to see this stuff working with the with the people walking through the terminal buildings and all that. So, but I think it's pretty good scenery. It seems to perform rather well. But certainly, decent scenery for sure. So, all right, well, we'll go ahead and get in. We'll jump in. Captain Maddie's ready to go. We're ready to go. So let's get the rest of this pre-flighted and ready to go. So let's go ahead and start the APU. Forward one, fuel pump, get the APU started, low oil pressure light coming on. What do you all think about the particle system? I still think that's a pretty nice addition to X-Plane, don't you? Isn't that cool? I like it. Oh, just for a little preview. Here it is, SimFans. I have not opened it. I've been like waiting. I've been waiting for this moment. I haven't even broken the tape. So that comes in once we get airborne, we'll crack that bad boy open and we'll see what that's all about. All right, so here in the APU, coming online. It's lit, as they say, right? It's lit. So let's jump back in the cockpit. Let's check and see what our exhaust gas temperature as it comes down. This blue light we're looking for. Now it's on. Now we can go ahead and switch over to APU for our power. And yes, sir. Generator switches are on, APU bleed. Get some air to our passengers. Get that turned on, all good. We'll switch the AC to APU. Parking brake I know is already set, I already checked that. We can now remove our ground connection. So we'll go back here. Ground services, GPU disconnect. Thank you. All right, done. Master caution light is on, of course, because we switched that over. So turn that off. And altimeter's all good. First altimeter set. We're going to be flying at 36,000 feet today, SimFans, or this evening. All the FMC stuff's done. Let's see. Are the gangway doors closed? And they are not. Cabin door closed. Not. We got our passengers back there, so get that closed up. Good deal. All right. Gangway doors. Generator bus transfer switch. That's done. Fuel pumps all on, and let's go ahead and get these all turned on. We'll get our hydraulic pumps all turned on, and we'll wait to turn on our anti-collision lights, which does work with the Alpha Flight Control SimFans, of course. All right, let's go ahead and pre-plan our pushback. I think I missed anything. So now we're going to go ahead and go to better pushback, all built in. Isn't that wonderful? Seamless. And we're going to be taking off from 28 right, SimFans. So I'm going to delete that entry because I want to modify this. How many of you out there use Better Pushback and fly X-Plane? I mean, for something that is free,
round a cockpit plan,
pretty wonderful, right?
Call me through the menu when you are ready.
We will do that, fine sir, fine ground crew. All right, so let's go ahead and do that. We'll call Better Pushback, get them over here. So we're going to hit request pushback.
Ground to cockpit. Tow is driving up.
Guess better get rid of these folks, huh? So we're going to go here to ground handling, show our control widget, and let's just do drive away. And we'll have them disembark. There's our... Hey, this is the beauty, right? Like, look at this guy. See, he can drive through the garage, and he can drive through walls. It's pretty cool stuff. Pretty cool technology. He's gonna go through the wall, of course. Right? There he goes. And over to our plane. There, look at that. Well, it's the technology today, SimFans. We don't have to abide by the laws of physics. Alright. Or something like that anyway, right? Alright, well, he's getting us hooked up there.
Okay. All doors and hatches are closed, ready to connect.
By the way, with the better pushback, you have sometimes it's pretty cool because if you're in different regions of the world, you'll have different accents, which I think is a nice touch. And there is a male and female voice, so pretty cool. Our ground service vehicles are now driving away. That's an add-on pack, by the way. Of course, like anything with X-Plane, I shouldn't say that, but a lot of things you got to pay for. And there's also things like better pushback. That's really cool. You don't have to pay for the ground service vehicles. You do have to pay for. All right. So they're away. Let's go ahead and turn them off.
And bypass pin inserted. Release parking brake.
Well, that was good timing, wasn't it? So we're just going to hide them. So they go away. Bye-bye. Total Bastard Airlines. Has anybody ever seen that skit from SNL? I'm going to age myself. All right, we're ready. So now all we have to do is go over to our Bravo Throttle Quadrant, turn off the parking brake, and they will start pushing us back.
And you may start engines.
Let's go inside here. Now we're going to turn on the beacon. Now we're going to hear the passengers kind of calm down. Maybe? All right. I did that a little late, by the way. Did anybody catch that? It's a little late. All right, we're going to turn our packs off. So left pack off, right pack off. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Okay, so our anti-collision lights are on, our packs are off, and our thrusts, we checked the honeycomb. Hey, SimFans, how you doing? So we got our throttle levers at fully idle. Pushback is started, and ignition switch is set to opposite. We're ready to go, so we're going to start. I always kind of like starting the right one first. So we're going to switch that to ground. Let's see if we can hear the sounds and fans as it lights up here. Starting up. And typically, yeah, when that valve closes, or the low oil pressure stops, then I like to go ahead and give it fuel. So let's see here. All right, Captain Maddie, Josiah's watching. Awesome, my friend, awesome. Hi, Josiah, how you doing? All right.
Operation complete, set parking brake.
Set a parking brake, got it. All right.
Connecting tow, standby.
Continuous, now we'll turn on our left. All right, so what I typically do is I'll watch for that low oil pressure light. Once that kicks off, right about one, yeah, there we go. Then I go ahead and I put in fuel, and that'll start that up, that left engine. Our better pushback is pulling back there. Very, very good. And then if we go back inside.
Tow is disconnected and bypass pin has been removed. Hand signal will be on the left. We'll see you next time. Have a safe flight.
Thank you. So put that to continuous on the left. All right. So go back up here. Okay, so now that we have our engines are fully lit and we have the engines, both engines on continuous, we're going to go ahead and turn the engine generator on. So we got those turned on. Now we'll go to Gen 1. There we go. APU we can now turn off. And of course, once we have the APU off, we can turn the bleed off from the APU. We don't pull air from that. And now we can set our packs back to auto. Airflow is going to continue in the cabin. Pitot heat switches on. Window heat, I'm just going to go ahead and turn those on, as well as the anti-ice for the engines. I know you're supposed to wait until you're below 10 degrees Celsius, but we're just gonna go ahead and do it now. Yaw damper turn to on. Flaps we're gonna set, so we're gonna set that. And by the way, one tip here. So I noticed the last time we were flying together, SimFans, whenever I would hit the flap, it would disengage the auto throttle. There is a setting for that in the Zibo. And I can show you that later if you're interested. Let me know in chat. Otherwise, I won't waste your time. But if you do not have it set, when you push honeycomb Bravo throttle quadrant anyway, when I was manipulating the flaps when I was going in for a landing, the auto throttle would disengage every time I changed that. So that was super annoying. But I found out that there is a setting in the Zibo settings that you can override that so it doesn't happen to you. So let me know if you're interested in that. I'll show you where it's at. Otherwise, we'll just continue on. All right, so we got our flap set. We need to set our auto brake. Aviation spotter, you had to remind me last time to turn that back off, and I appreciate that. Pushback is done. Taxi lights going on. It's the thing with these planes, right? If you have a general aviation aircraft, it's like, light it up, go. I mean, for the most part. Runway turnoff lights go on. Those are on. Right. Autopilot is set. Let's make sure that we don't have anything that is needing. Yep, disengage bar is up. Flight directors, we want to get those both on. Flight director, and then of course auto throttle arm. And we have our indicated airspeed, so our rotate will be 152, indicated airspeed. Our heading to runway heading will be taking off from 28 right, so let's go ahead and get that to 280. And I could use my, by the way, I could use my Honeycomb Bravo Throttle Quadrant, but I watch for version 2.0 review. I've got some things I want to comment on that. I think it's good for fine tuning, but because how small the diameter of this dial is, you're going to be rotating that a long time. So I still use the virtual cockpit for major changes, and then if I have to fine tune it, I'll use the Honeycomb. But I'm going to do, watch for that. I'm going to do some fans a version 2 review of the Honeycomb Bravo Throttle Quadrant now that I've had several months of using it, and highlight the things I really, really like and some of the things that are good but could be improved. Check initial altitude is at 36,000 feet, so we are good. So now we're ready to go ahead and taxi. I've shown all of you this before. There's a plugin called ABS, and it'll let you see around the airport. But one thing I wanted to show all of you is if you hit taxiways, it's not so great with this Nimbus payware. It doesn't actually have the routing for all the taxiways, and it must just be the way that Nimbus did the, or they didn't do the taxiways for it. I don't know for sure why, but it's one of the few airports that actually doesn't have the full taxiways. So I can't really use this. I mean, I can kind of see, you know, we're right here in 28, right? You know, I can kind of tell where that's at, but at the same time, it's not the greatest for this airport, this payware scenery. All right, SimFan, so I think we're ready to go. We've got our flaps down. Let's go ahead and start taxiing. And we are a-rolling. And of course, we're using the track IR tonight to look around our aircraft. Just double check and make sure our speed brake works. All good. All right. Ailerons work, spoilers work. Take a look from the outside, always fun to do. So how is everybody doing tonight? Hopefully well, hopefully everybody's doing great. It's Thursday, Sim fans, right? We're only one more day from the weekend. Hang in there. I know I am. Always helps to get through an evening when we're all together, right? Or through a week. Beautiful livery, though, isn't it? Got an aircraft taking off ahead of us, it looks like. Is that an Embraer? Sure what that is in front of us. Maybe it's a CRJ. Another aircraft ahead of us. There's another 7-3. Of course, Chicago O'Hare being one of the American domiciles, right, for the hubs. So look at that Lufthansa. Woo! Look at that. 7-4 Lufthansa. Nice. Should fly one of those sometime, and I could put like the four throttle levers on the Bravo and give that a workout, huh? Wouldn't that be nice? I do have the 747 for X-Plane. Who is the developer for that? I'm trying to remember. There's a couple of them out there, but I've got whatever one's the better one. I can't think of it right now. I'm just so much into Microsoft Flight Simulator anymore. Yeah, that's an Embraer, right? Is that a 145? Look at this guy cutting us off, that bastard. That's all right. Oh, I shouldn't swear, should I, Captain Maddie? He got Josiah in front of this screen. he's getting out of our way. That's all right. All right. So the thing with O'Hare, just so many runways. So many runways. All right. There goes the... is that Embraer or is that a CRJ, SimFans? What is that? We're not gonna, did I miss my turn? I did. Oops. All right, my bad. I was so focused on that that CRJ or Embraer, whatever that was. I went right past our turn off there. See, that's the problem with getting too dependent on that AVS, that airport visual system. I go right by our turn there. My bad. Bear with me, Sim fans. Bear with me. Look at all the traffic, though. Again, we're using Traffic Global tonight. All right. We'll make sure we take off the right runway, especially since we have our departure and the FMC all plugged in. We want to make sure we take off from the right runway here. All right, Sim fans, here we go. Okay, let's put on the parking brake and let's get ready to rock and roll here. Let's zoom out a little bit, but there's our first intersection. So we're gonna take off and go just slightly to the left. And let's check our checklist here again. Holding point, we gotta get our landing lights on, and that does work with the Alpha Flight Control, so turn those on. Landing lights are on, runway turn lights are on, taxi lights can go off, our wing light goes on. Put our strobes on, good to go, TCAS. Get that set. Turn that off here.
The cabin is secured. Have a good flight.
Thank you. Get our TCAS set. There we go, we're all set to go. Some fans, I think. TCAS transponder, all great. Ready for takeoff, parking brake off, thrust levers. All right, we're ready to go, some fans. Let's rock and roll out of here. All right, here we go. Push forward on that yoke until we hit 80 knots. Get more directional control for our nose wheel. And then once we hit 80 knots, we can let our rudder take over.
80 knots.
Got enough airflow over that rudder. Now that can keep our nose pointed down the runway, center line. Nice textures. Nice textures, by the way, on the runway here, I think.
V1.
Rotate.
Positive rate.
You're up.
400.
Mark, I'm trying to get that 173.
1,000.
Just some trimming. Oh yeah, aviation spotter, take off roll, my friend. Absolutely. We're hitting right about that 173, so we're doing good, sim fans. All right, let's go ahead and hit VNAV, LNAV, and command. Wait a minute, what are you doing? What's it doing? For some reason it wanted to switch on us. What are you doing? Not quite sure why that just happened. Turn our RTO off. I'll remember this time, aviation spotter. Got that turned off. Go ahead and put flaps up a bit. Trim her out a little bit. All right, let's try that again. Not quite sure why the LNAV switched on us. Just gonna do it again. Let's see if it evens out here. I'm gonna take my hands off. But it really started turning last time. Did you guys see that? That was crazy. Although I'm zoomed out quite a bit, that's probably why. There we go. Flyby time. LOL stall. All right, so 250 right along with the FMC. Looking good, looking good. Why does it keep warning us that the autopilot is disconnecting? What is up with that crap? By the way, we're not flying by it tonight, sim fans, but I do have the add-on scenery from Orbix for downtown Chicago, which is kind of cool because it includes the MiGs airfield, which is pretty slick. And it does perform better in X-Plane, of course, as opposed to Microsoft Flight Simulator, where if some of you have caught some of those streams, it gets pretty horrendous, especially after the... Sim update 3, it was really bad, but sounds like Microsoft and Zibo are working on that, so we'll give them some time. We'll give them benefit of the doubt, and we'll give them some time, but they better get that stuff fixed, right? By golly. Let me see if I turn that autopilot on there. Yeah, something's weird. Something weird's going on. Like, I updated the Zibo to the latest. And so I don't know if there's some bugs here, but like, yeah, I mean, did you notice how our angle of attack was? That was pretty crazy. Something's a little off here. I don't know. We're like taking off like a Blue Angels F-A-18 right there. What the heck? It might be a combination of things, you know, with like the Bravo throttle quadrant and that, but it's, hopefully got it out of its system. Let's do a flyby, SimFans. Let's do a flyby. All right. Is it stabilizing? Does this seem like it's stabilizing now, SimFans? That's kind of been crazy there. Haven't had quite that many problems with the autopilot system. And no, the one thing I noticed, though, I turned on autopilot and it didn't light up here on the Honeycomb Bravo Throttle Quadrant. So I'm not quite sure why that is, because we've got heading, altitude, and indicated airspeed all lit up here, but it doesn't light up here. And I don't know if how many of you fly X-Plane? Because it works perfectly fine on Microsoft Flight Simulator. And I don't know this for sure, but I think before I did the latest Zibo update, that worked. And I don't know. I don't want to say for sure that it's from the latest Zibo update, because I haven't confirmed that, but it does seem like I have some additional bugs since I last updated this aircraft. So I don't know. It could be just my system. I don't want to give a wrong impression that it's the aircraft, but I can't help but wonder. T-Mac, hi, how are you doing, T-Mac? Welcome to the stream. T-Mac, thank you for subscribing. I saw that you subscribed to my channel earlier today, so cheers, my friend. Thank you so much. I do not have the A300, T-Mac. I do not have that. You know, I thought about getting that. I do have the A319. You know, by Tullis. I'm going to be doing an unboxing here shortly of the, I got the Airbus throttle pack from Honeycomb. I pre-ordered it, which you all can pre-order. I meant to put a link, but you can just go to Honeycomb's site. I know you all can find it. But I got an alert today on my, or yesterday on my phone, and a text message, and it's like, hey, it shipped. And I'm like, sweet, because I thought it was supposed to ship Monday, which I think they actually did. Because I got the message on my cell phone yesterday that it shipped from Hong Kong. And I'm like, well, I won't see them for a week. And I was like, oh, it's fine. I got to get proficient with the Airbus anyway. So I'm like, that's fine. And then it was kind of like the Bravo Throttle Quadrant, because I pre-ordered that as well. And I thought, well, maybe it will show up quickly. I'm not kidding you. I got the notification, SimFans, yesterday, and it arrived today. So I'm almost positive. I mean, think about it. Honeycomb shipped, had these shipped from Hong Kong on Monday, and it arrived today on Thursday. That's pretty fast. So again, I've got it right over here. I haven't even broken the seal on it yet. So I'm going to open it up, and then we'll pull the levers out, take a look at those here live. We'll go ahead and throw them on the Bravo Throttle Quadrant. Hopefully I don't mess up our flight too much while doing it, but just to kind of see how it looks. But, Passenger Escobar.
To a special meal, would you please identify yourself to a flight attendant? Passenger Escobar, please.
I'm Escobar. Give me my free meal. So we'll be opening that here shortly. But pretty cool stuff. My intent is not to make you wait either. I want to make sure we're in cruise and everything's stable before I open it and get distracted with it. So, so it'd be fun. Hey, I understand, T-Mac. That's all right. If you can't stay long, no worries. Thank you for joining the live stream, though. Appreciate it. Thank you. Time for a flyby. The thing that we get in X-Plane, right? That beautiful F-Mod sound. Gosh, I just love that, SimFans. Don't you? I mean, the F-Mod sound. I mean, okay, the CRJ 550 and 700 and Microsoft Flight Simulator sounds really good, but without the F-Mod sound, without the flyby, we just don't get to hear it. That Doppler effect, right? The Doppler effect where it's coming at you and then goes by. That's so cool. switch over to standard pressure. All right, standard pressure, we're good. We can now turn off our lights, so we're gonna turn off the landing lights. Those are off, we'll turn off the runway turn off lights, and we will turn off our wing and wheel well. And now we'll do another flyby so we can see that the lights are no longer on. Amazing. Aviation Spider says, what of these flyby views? You're bound to have a CRJ off your left wing. Hey, Aviation Spider, I saw that you were, you're an X-Plane. I saw that you were playing X-Plane, so I wouldn't doubt it, my friend. I'm always waiting for you to swing by. Although I'm not running multiplayer, so that would be a trick. But no, that's awesome, man. And I know you're joking around, but that's good stuff, because I always look for you to be off my left wing, or right wing, or above me, or below, somewhere. They're coming right at me doing a flyby. Good stuff. So I was thinking about this weekend, and like where we should fly this weekend. And you know, we aren't that far away from the multiplayer fly-in. So I was thinking about, well, so I know Frank, when he was on, Frank Rose, he's the ramp guy at Toronto and works for Air Canada. But he mentioned, you know, doing a flight in Hawaii. And I know, Captain Maddie, I know you mentioned a few options as well. I know, like, way back when. See, I don't have as bad a memory as you think. You mentioned, like, flying maybe to Mexico City and I think it was like San Diego, Mexico City, maybe somewhere there. But so, yeah, I'm trying to figure out exactly like what we should do for some flights in, you know, for Saturday. So let me know in chat what you think, what you want to fly. That'll be a Microsoft Flight Simulator. We'll do a Microsoft Flight Simulator flight on Saturday night, same time, 8:30 Central Standard Time. So looking forward to that. So yeah, let me know what you all would like to see. By the way, check the details below. I do have a Discord server. If you want to post, you know, screenshots, images, what have you, feel free to post. You know, so that's a good area because obviously you can't post and chat on YouTube. So definitely a place for you to post your pictures. Okay, Aviation Spider says Hawaii. All right, we'll take a look at having it be Hawaii. Oh, didn't mean to hit enter Hawaii, but that might be a little short. Yeah, I was thinking like we could do like island hopping, Aviation. I was thinking maybe we could do some island hopping. Like maybe we could do like Kauai, there's Lihue, Oahu, you know, Honolulu International, for the Big Island, and Maui, I can't think of the airport there, but I thought, you know, maybe we could just do like some island hopping and some GA aircraft, right? What do you think about that, Aviation and others? Kind of wondering if that might be something we want to tackle or not, but. Hi, Brian Lofton. Welcome to the stream, my friend. Brian Lofton says, what's the best P for flight sim? Okay, well, there's a lot of, it depends, Brian, on what your budget is. You know, ultimately, if you're asking, like, ultimately, what's the best PC, I think still giving the cores and stuff like that, I think you're still better off with an Intel processor rather than the AMD, even though the AMD 5900X and 5950X really blows away the Intel on performance, but I still think that you're probably better off with the Intel. Also, don't worry. It depends on for your graphics card. Don't waste your money. The graphics cards are so expensive right now that you really want to look at what your resolution you're trying to push out your video. And so, you know, I know some of you. I used to have triple displays, triple monitors, but then I condensed it down to one widescreen Alienware 34-inch. That's a 2K monitor. It's 3440 by 1440 for the resolution. For a 2K monitor, don't go. There's no reason to go above a NVIDIA 3070. There's just no reason to do it. But if you want to do 4K, or if you have multi monitor setups, then it might make sense to jump up to 3080. Get some additional memory, you know, your VRAM. So keep that in mind. But you know, honestly, I mean, I'm running right now, Brian, I'm running on a decent budget. Yeah, I would say probably like maybe an AMD 3700X. And again, and the things I said about the video, don't waste your money. The video, and if you can wait, this is my advice. If you can wait, if you want the NVIDIA or the 6000 series, and I do recommend those because of the ray tracing, and I think that Flight Simulator and other stuff will take advantage of ray tracing later on. Right now, it almost looks like it's using it. But I definitely go with the 3000 card. NVIDIA has released they've actually gone back and released the 2000 series. So like the 2080, the 2070, 2060. But ray tracing, they just don't perform. I mean, I would not get those. If you're planning on doing either, you want it for 3 or 4 years, 5 years, whatever, I would definitely stick with an RTX with a 3000 series video card. That's my opinion. Definitely if you're running 2K, don't get a 3080. And for God's sakes, don't spend like $1,300 on a 10 or a 3090. You're wasting your money. Now there's cheaper video cards. Like I'd say if you're on a decent budget, you can find a decent system. You're not going to get a 3000 card, you're not going to get a 6000 card from AMD, 3000 card from Nvidia, but you can get a decent system that can run Microsoft Flight Simulator you know, for like $1,400 if you can. You know, I know it's expensive, but see, the thing is, sim fans, it's just like everything is expensive right now. It's so hard to find stuff. Because everybody is buying this stuff up. It's not just gamers. It's everything. I won't even talk about I've talked about the crypto mining, but that pisses me off. I'm sorry. The crypto mining just... And now, have you seen the ads with, like, the credit cards using cryptocurrency? It's just, you're just encouraging people. And by the way, I don't mean to offend anybody. If you're mining, I more power to you, but... It's the ones that buy up, like, you know, with the bots, they buy up like 30 NVIDIA cards, and they use them for nothing but running 24/7 crypto mining to earn money. And now all of us gamers, we either can't get them or we got to pay out the yin yang for them. Anyway, no, don't get a 3090. Yeah, don't get a 3090, Brian. You're wasting your money. I mean, you can buy a whole entire system. And here's the sad thing, folks. They're, you know, gamers are actually buying, because right now the only way you can get them are by OEM, so pre-built. That's the only way you're going to get a, if unless you're on a waiting list. And I've been on a waiting list, by the way, since October. I've been on a waiting list, EVGA's waiting list, since October, and I haven't gotten a single word from them. I had a friend that finally was on a waiting list since September, so I'm hoping I'll get pinged here at some point. He finally got an opportunity to buy a 3080 card at MSRP, and he'd be a fool not to. And he bought it, and he's just sitting on it. Because he bought a 2080, I think, Ti. But yeah, I mean, so the only way to get them right now, the 3060, the 37, 3080, is either be on a waiting list, and if you haven't been on a waiting list for a long time, is to buy pre-built. Because the OEM, the manufacturers, are the first ones to get those cards. And you can get them. So there are actually PC builders like myself. They'll actually go out and buy a pre-built machine for like $2,000 to get the card. You know, and then they'll build what they want. So everything's a premium right now. So my advice, Brian, is if you can wait. I don't know what you have right now, my friend. But my advice is if you can wait until next year, things should start getting better. We should see, at least the things I've researched and read, it's going to be a while. It's going to be like next year. Like initially I thought maybe May this year, maybe June. I don't think so. I think it's going to, it sounds like it's going to be next year before everything starts normalizing and price points come down. And remember the day when you could just go buy a video card? Like, oh yeah, $700, but everywhere was in stock. You could buy it. You didn't have to be on a waiting list. You didn't have to pay like these, you know, these scalper prices. It's like we hit the perfect storm with the pandemic and everybody being at home and needing to have PCs, not just gamers, but people just buying computers to work from home remotely. It's just insane. It's like the perfect storm. And then the cryptocurrency coming back and resurgence there. It's all of those things, sim fans. It's just making it so hard on us as gamers. And by the way, don't buy what, you know, if NVIDIA says, oh, we're out there for the gamers, that's not true. It's not. They're out there to make money. You know, they put these restrictions on the new GPUs to try to avoid the crypto miners. They get hacks for them and they work around it. It's a joke. So it's not. There used to be a time where it was just us gamers. Ooh, we got traffic. Off to our right, really close, like, let's take a look. Yep, there he is. Oh, we're flying nice and close. Look at that. Holy shit. Wow! If I didn't know better, I'd think that was Aviation Spotter. Now that is definitely where TCAS comes into play, and we really should have we should have went downwards. I think that's the closest I've ever seen the AI traffic come. That's pretty cool. How about that, sim fans? That's pretty neat. Never seen it that close before. Not without it being intentional.
How's it go?
All right, almost at 1,000 feet. We're almost hitting our cruise altitude, sim fans. So once we hit our cruise, I'm going to kick on the tunes, take a quick break. I've got a nature calls. I'm going to refill my eggnog. It's not really eggnog, right? That's an expression. Who can guess the film? That's an easy one, by the way. And then we're going to do the unboxing. As soon as I get back, we'll do the unboxing. So once we hit cruise here, we'll... Here's another one. What the? Now, where's he at? Say he's like right ahead of us. Yep, right there. Actually, let's go in the cockpit because we can see him right in front of us. So I'm using Traffic Global. And like you can see, there's a lot. Aviation Smart. Aviation. Traffic Global AI is like you flying with me, man. My friend. Yeah, that is close. That absolutely was close. All right, we're at our cruising altitude, sim fans. So let's do our checklist, my high-tech paper checklist here. I know. So climb, we had our auto brake off. We turned our landing lights off. Wheel well. Window heat we already had on. NI ice. We adjusted for transition altitude. We're all good. Cruising, we just basically got to keep checking our fuel consumption. Our center fuel, we've got... tons of fuel. We have way more fuel than we need. You know what? I think I forgot to turn. Yeah, see, I forgot to turn the center fuel pumps on. So we'll turn those on so we can start burning some of that center. Now we got it burning here. See? Oops. I forgot to turn the center fuel pumps on. Now we notice that's going to start going down, and then these stabilize and stop. Okay. So yeah. Sim fans, yeah. How about some tunes, huh? What do you think? Let's start rocking this joint. Okay, sim fans. So let's take a 5-minute break now that we're in cruise, and I'll go on the outside view here so you guys can all see the aircraft flying by us so closely. So we'll come back, 5-minute break, go get yourself a Fresca. Get yourself a snack, because it's going to be a nice flight. We're going to do an unboxing here shortly of the Honeycomb Airbus Throttle Pack. And we'll continue chatting and having fun with our flight. So, SimFans, we'll be right back. Catch you soon. Stick around. Don't leave, because we're going to do the unboxing here shortly. Okay, I am back. Took a little longer than I planned. Wife got home, so. All right, Sim fans. Let me get situated. All right. Entirely too many, like, things in OBS. So we're still flying, that's good. We didn't have anybody crash into us. Aviation Spotter says, I've never seen such a close encounter in a simulator. Wow, yeah, right? I haven't either, honestly. That is the first time I've ever seen that close of an encounter. Aviation Spotter. All right, let's get this set up. So here's, I'm gonna actually, let's do this. Get the, put the checklist to the side. Let's get this bigger. Oh, you can see my TPR pedals right there, Sim fans. Check that out. Now we see see more stuff there. Can everybody see this now? Is that? Oh yeah, you can see that, right? Okay. All right, now for the unboxing, Sim fans. I'll open this, make it a little bit bigger. I got this kind of zoomed in a ways here, but so I'll go ahead and cut that this open. Right, let's go right here. All right, here we go. Watch me cut myself on the air. It's kind of like bulging. Keep it clean. All right. You should always cut away from yourself, right? All right, let's see. Put this aside before I do cut myself. Okay, well that's good. We actually have a throttle pack box. Let's pull this bad boy out. That's one thing I will say. So if any of you have ever had, if you've ordered the Alpha Flight Controls or the Bravo Throttle Quadrant, it is really nice that they put this stuff inside another box. 2-year warranty. And they always have these sleeves too. Just taped? The hell? That's probably taped. Honest to God. Never seen a person have such a hard time opening a damn box. Is it heavy? It's Aviation Spotter. I wouldn't say it's heavy. It's probably, I'd guess it's probably about maybe only a pound and a half, 2 pounds. So no, not really heavy. You know what? It's probably about as heavy as the commercial levers. I would say that would be a good comparison. As a matter of fact, it looks like about the same size of box. So for those of you that already have the Bravo Quadrant, you know that all the commercial stuff connects to, that's about the same thing. So we got our little guide here. So it all looks good. See that? So yeah, I mean, foam pad like they always do. Oh, they got each one individually wrapped with cellophane. How about that? And look at this, SimFans. They've all got reversers. So just like the regular levers, but you got the reverser, which will be just a switch, I'm sure, right? So these are all gonna be pretty much, should be the same. They all have reversers, as you can see. I'm not gonna take all the cellophane off now. Oh, no, they all don't. Here, look at this. So then you got the, well, that makes sense. It's like the toga control there, little button, just like we have on the controls that come with it. So that's different. So I assume this probably goes like, you know, right over here, I would assume, on the outside. So there's that. And there's one other one. Is this, yeah, so that's, actually that's got it too. Got the little toga button there as well. So it looks like there's two of those, and I assume those all will go on the outside. So they'll go on the outside, and then you have the two inner ones that actually have the reversers. So these both have the reversers. Now let's get to our flap lever. All right, so it looks like this here would be our flap lever, I'm guessing. So it's, yeah, I mean, that's basically it, SimFans. It's just like the box, like the commercial stuff fits into. That's pretty cool. I like it. And speed brake, or maybe I got them backwards. They're kind of small. They're kind of tiny. Come on, out of there. There we go. So, which one is that? I should know this. Let's go to our reference box here. Oh, okay, so this one would be our flap lever. And of course, it's got the opening there to fit right here. So, and then on the left would be our speed brake and then all the controls. So, what the hell, let's put them on. Y'all came to fly with me tonight, so let's go ahead and see if I can't mess up our flight. So we're just gonna go ahead and take, I'm gonna try to do this carefully. So we're gonna take this off. Our flap lever off. And I just disengaged autopilot. Give me 1 second. We're back. All right, and I'm gonna try to do this carefully, but you notice like there's these little, shit. Maybe I should be doing this right now. But there's these little rubber access covers, which is nice. So I'll put that over there. Let me turn autopilot back on. Obviously, the aircraft is designed to do that. You know what? It's going to keep happening and doing that, so I might wait. Or do you all want me to put these on? Hi, Aviation Spotter. So you basically bought an A320 without the type rating. Yes. Do you all want me to put these on now, or just maybe I'll do another flight or a review? I mean, this is it though. I mean, what you see is what you get, I guess. I'm kind of impressed. I mean, they actually put cellophane around every one of the little cellophane bags around every one of these. That's kind of cool. By the way, this cost me $69.99 US. You can buy it, at least the last I checked, you can buy it now, but Let me know in chat. You want me to put these on, or should we just continue flying? I mean, I will. I guess what I could do is put us in pause and then do it, but... But yeah, they fit pretty nicely inside this box here. So... Oh, you know what? Screw it. We're gonna do it. We're gonna do it. Let me pause the sim. I'm gonna pause the sim, because then that way we won't lose... Let's go ahead and take these off. Take that off. Take that off. Ah. Take the other rubber deal off. And, okay, so this, trying to see which way this goes. So this would go here, I think. You're not. Probably should read the directions, huh? So if we had the four here, and I'm just looking at this here. So that goes right on there. All right. And this one would go here. Just like that. And then we got the one with the reverser. So that's going to go... I don't know if it really matters. This will go here. Right there. Here we go. Everybody see that? Everybody see it? Everybody see it? All right. That goes on the outside. This one goes next to that one. Of course, we'd have the reverser switch on the outside. So that's going to go there. And then lastly, the one with our toga on the right. Really hard to see it with these sunglasses on. There you go, Sim fans. Oh, wait, forgot one piece. And then, of course, our speed brake. And of course, I put it on the wrong way. There we go. Easy peasy. There you go. And then you got your reversers right here. They feel pretty nice. I mean, those are pretty easy to flip back and forth. And of course, you can bring them down here too. So you can actually use the access control for doing reverse like that. Or you can use these as just plain switches, you know, if you wanted to use those. And then of course, if you want to do just like the A319 configuration, you know, you just do the two of them. I mean, pretty straightforward. But there you have it, Sim fans. That'll conclude our unboxing of the Honeycomb throttle pack for those of us that are lucky to have our Bravo throttle quadrant. So $70. If you're an Airbus fan, probably worth it. You might want to give it a buy. All right. I'm just gonna drop these back in here, and then we'll continue our flight. Ugh. Back in this, I also like the fact that they have the nice containers that have the little, it's like kind of like a little bit of a magnetic closure there with the little pull tab, and that's kind of nice that, you know, and they all fit in there, which is really great. So let's get this last one off here, and so they just, yeah, I mean, pretty straightforward, but they just drop right in there like that, and that one in, right in there, and then of course we have our speed brake. That's it. There you go, Sim fans. Hopefully it was worth the wait. I don't know, was it? All right, so now we get our get this put back together, and then we'll turn off pause and continue our flight. Put that back on. These, we go down like this, and again, we have these rubber access covers. By the way, when you put these on, don't push. I had a tendency to push on the trim wheel here, and I don't wanna like bend that, so kind of be careful and aware of that. So just kind of best thing is to just put them on straight on like that. Speed brake. There, And of course our flap lever right back there. Make sure those are up so when we're flying, I think we can take it out now. Figured that was gonna happen. There we go. Man back on and we're flying, SimFans. Good to go. We'll shrink this back down. All right, well, oh, I expand this out a little bit. What do you guys think? Do you like it or no? Aviation says, whatever's easier. Yeah, well, you know, I figured you all would like to see that, or maybe once this is saved and is out there, others can check it out. What do you guys think? Do you want to keep the tunes going? You want to do a little jazz? Should be. Is it too loud? What do you think, Aviation? Well, I do need to get proficient, right? I'm being kind of cheesy because I do realize if I wanted to do this unboxing right, I would have been flying an Airbus tonight. So I submit to all of you that yes, you got me. I should have. I haven't flown the Airbus for a while. Like I said, I have the Tolos and X-Plane. I could have flown that tonight, but I just need to get proficient with it and do some flights. I've been so heavy into Microsoft Flight Simulator lately that just haven't been doing a lot of flying in X-Plane. I've flown the A320 with the fly-by-wire in Microsoft Flight Simulator, but I just have been doing so much GA, as all of you know, that watch my stream. Been doing a lot of that for a while, so I just need to get proficient in Airbus. So I will do that. I still need to do a stream with the CRJ. I've had that for a while from Aerosoft. All right, Aviation, you like the Yeah, I like them. They seem to be, they're pretty nice, my friend. Get them back in the sleeve. I don't know. I probably should just leave the sleeve off because it's the sleeve's kind of tight. sorry. But no, I'm $70. I mean, think about it. Like, my son, a lot of times, he'll want to spend like $100 on, like, you know, Call of Duty with all the additional stuff, or, you know, whatever game that's just released, you know, MLB The Show and stuff like that. So it's like, okay, for $70, I'll have this for the life of the quadrant. It's going to be worth it to switch over to. So definitely don't miss out. Let me do something really quick here. So if you want to check it out, all you have to do, let's see if they're still available. I know you can all find this as well, but let's see if they're still available. Can you still order them, pre-order them? I assume you can. Yeah, you can still pre-order some fans. Absolutely. So to get these, all you gotta do, go to Honeycomb site. They are there. Honeycomb Aeronautical, by the way. Products. Flight Sim Hardware. Throttle pack for Airbus A319 to A380. There you have it. So, $70, you can pre-order now. I think they're pretty much shipping them. From what I've seen and read, it looks like they're pretty much shipping them as soon as you order them. So, I mean, notice if you go to that link, it says add to cart. It doesn't say pre-order anymore. I don't know how soon they ship them. I assume they ship them fairly quick, but they are coming from, at least if you order off a Honeycomb site, I believe they're all coming from Hong Kong, unless maybe they are shipping a bunch of them to a warehouse here in the U.S., maybe in Europe, a few locations maybe. I don't know. But you can order them now, which is kind of nice, because everything Honeycomb we've always had to wait for. But I guess that's because there's probably a lot of you that are still waiting for the Bravo Quadrant to be able to use the darn things anyway. So, but if you have a Bravo Throttle Quadrant or you have one on order and it's coming, I'd go ahead and get them if you're an Airbus fan, for sure. We're, what's $70, right? In the long run, it's another, I don't know. I mean, the others work, so whatever. You know, if you want. More authentic experience. Let's check out our progress, SimFans. Let's see how far we have until the top of our descent, huh? Let's go over to our right FMC. And let's hit the prog button. And we can see that our top of descent is at 1933 Zulu, which is a little less than an hour and 20 minutes, so not too shabby. Yeah, we're doing pretty good on time, SimFans, for sure. Now we want to check our time to touch or to landing. We'll be at Albuquerque at 1951 is what we're projecting. So what is that? 51, so 40, basically 35 minutes. Our 35 minutes will be land. We'll be at the gate. If so Aviation Spotter asks, if Honeycomb released a Delta set, what do you think it will be? I don't know. That's a good question. I don't know. What do you think? You know, that's a good question, Aviation Spotter. That'd be pretty cool, wouldn't it? Yeah, I don't know. You know they're going to have more stuff coming out. You know, they're almost like, it's kind of neat that they want to, they're your typical engineers, right? It's like, okay, we got done with this project, now let's move on to the next thing and see how cool we can make it, which is awesome. I won't lie, that is cool. But up the manufacturing, but I mean, what a time to have this happen, right? During the pandemic and everybody's like isolated and natural resources, raw materials are at a high demand and all that stuff. So what a time. But yeah, I mean, it's like, okay, the Charlie pedals are coming out. I don't know. That's probably coming, Aviation. You know they're going to have more stuff. I honestly anticipate in the next few years, Honeycomb is going to have other stuff that's going to come out, like maybe a comm panel. Because they don't have the comp stuff on the Bravo Quadrant, right? They have the autopilot stuff, which is great, but no communication panel. So they'll probably do that. I wouldn't be surprised if they actually did an FMC, to be honest with you guys. I mean, I don't know. Maybe they never will, but I wouldn't be surprised. The rate they're going. Again, did all of you know that Honeycomb, they're basically aerospace engineers from what I've read. And obviously out in California, I think San Diego area, right? Correct me if I'm wrong on that in chat. But yeah, some of them are real pilots, some of them are just sim enthusiasts, and they were sick and tired of the kind of either you had just the cheapest stuff that you can get that was kind of so-so to like thousands of dollars to get like authentic stuff, and they wanted to come in at a price point for all of us that we'd get all the features and functionality of these controls that we'd want at a good price, and they do have good prices. And you know, like what the Alpha, I think, is a 4-year warranty. I'm kind of surprised it's only a 2-year warranty, to be honest with all of you. There's another plane that just blew by us. I'm surprised that that throttle pack is only 2 years. That's kind of interesting, because it's plastic. I mean, sure, there's a couple switches on the, you know, the toga and the reversers, but it's like 4 or 5 years. Correct me if I'm wrong, SimFans, but I think it's 4 or 5 years on the Alpha and Bravo quadrants. So I don't know why they only have 2 years on some plastic pieces, but maybe because they're interchanging all the time. That kind of surprises me that they didn't keep that to the standard 4 to 5 years. Probably doesn't matter. I mean, really, are they going to break? Unless you're doing something stupid and really forcing them on there. But you're probably going to break the, I don't know. You'd probably break the handles. I don't know. But We're not going to do that. But yeah, pretty cool. We got to do a flyby. We haven't done a flyby for a long time since we like left Chicago. See, you can. We're flying with ortho scenery today, SimFans. So we're using the ortho satellite imagery that I've downloaded and put it on some of my Western Digital black drives. 2 8-terabyte black drives. Let me do a sound check here, quick. There we go. I forgot to unmute. I'm talking to myself. God, in this day and age, you'd think I'd know by now. Unmute the microphone. No, what I was just saying is, welcome Aces, by the way. Aces in the house. Welcome Aces. Good to have you, my friend. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Thank you, Aces, for confirming that. So San Diego is right. Okay, awesome. Yeah. Yeah. Well, aren't you all supposed to be able to read my lips? Know what I'm saying? I mean, come on. My bad. So anyway, Honeycomb's going to have some cool stuff, for sure. God, how long was I muted there for? Not that long, right? Hopefully. So we're making good time, SimFans, tonight. We really are. We really are making good time. Man, look at this traffic. Aviation, I mean, these AI aircraft are just buzzing us left and right. What's going on with that? It's crazy. God, I love that. By the way, this new livery, I think it's so sweet. With all the black soot and dirt and marks on it. That's so awesome. Looks so good, SimFans. Okay, thanks, Aces. I was hoping not long, my friend. Well, welcome, Aces. It's good to have you here. How's everything, Aces? Hopefully well. How's it for everybody out there? Aces, did you miss our unboxing? You might have to go back on the stream, Aces, because I just got done doing the live stream unboxing of the Honeycomb Airbus throttle pack. So, Aces, I know you got the Bravo now, my friend. What do you think? It's good, right? Huh. Well, he wishes he could be closer. I'm not on multiplayer, so, but if I was, I know he would be like right off my left wing. He'd be right off my left wing. For sure. So, yeah, so definitely, Aces, I don't know. I mean, for $70, I'm just saying to the SimFans here on the channel, on the stream, I think it's, you know, $70 is a little pricey, but when I start thinking about, okay, they actually have the little switches for the toga and for the reversers, I don't know. I mean, it's a little pricey. I mean, but $70 in the grand scheme of things, I don't know. It's like buying an Xbox game, right? I mean, those are $60, but I was just like, okay, I buy those games, and if I even play them all the way through, it's like this I'll have for the whole time I have the Bravo Quadrant. So, there's always a way to reason to yourself to make a purchase, isn't there, Sim fans? I mean, there's always a way, right? Yeah, definitely check that out, Aces. I like it. I don't know. I gotta use them. Like I was telling everybody, I need to get proficient with the Airbus. If I was gonna do this right for the unboxing, I do realize. I just want to say that I realize I should have been flying an Airbus tonight, but they came today. I wasn't even expecting it. I got a text message yesterday, like I said, and it's like, "Oh, your Honeycomb order is shipped," and it said Hong Kong. So like, oh yeah, that's gonna show up next week unless it's like my Bravo Throttle Quadrant and it shows up the next day. It was like that. It showed up today, so. Didn't give me time to practice up on the Airbus. Yeah, Recon Delta could do it, right? For sure. I haven't seen Recon tonight yet. I don't know if he's gonna be able to join us tonight or not. Aces. Yeah, so some of you have been with me the whole time that it started. We took off from Chicago, so we're flying from Chicago here to Albuquerque. We took off from the Nimbus payware at Chicago, and I'm trying to remember the name. Something Final is the Albuquerque. I'll look it up here. Well, I've got it linked below. Check it out below. But anyway, yeah, we're flying into Albuquerque, but I got everything loaded, and... It's like 13 minutes till the stream started, and I like looked. I'm like, where the hell's X-Plane at? And it crashed the desktop. What the heck? So I had reloaded all the FMC and all that stuff. Not a big deal, but I was like ready to go. I was like ready for pushback, and then I had to reload it. So I caught everybody about right after I got the FMC program. We had to start from there, but no big deal. It happens. I don't know, but the last couple streams, I had that happen like last Thursday when I did X-Plane. X-Plane just, no error, nothing. It just, boom, desktop. Hi, Khan. Welcome to the stream. Thank you for joining us. Actually, Khan, I am flying. We're flying an X-Plane tonight, and we're flying the Zibo 737. So I was just mentioning, if I was going to do it right, I should have done the Airbus, I realize. But no, I already had everything ready to go with the Zibo. So we're doing the 7-3, but I will do a future live stream. I'll get proficient in the Airbus, I promise. We'll maybe do the A319, or maybe we'll do the Microsoft Flight Simulator A320 with the fly-by-wire version. And then we'll do the... We'll do this. There it is. And essentially, it comes in the same kind of box that the commercial throttle levers come with when you buy the Bravo. Pretty much the same thing, which is nice. I really like that. So, yeah. Welcome, Khan. Glad to have you. I know I think I've chatted with you within the post and that. So, welcome. Thanks for joining us tonight. Anybody know any good, like, pilot jokes? I was thinking about, like, looking some up that we could maybe have a few laughs with. Post them in chat if you have some good pilot jokes, if you would. Maybe we can get a few good laughs. Mine's still stuck in Oakland. Aviation Spotter, I mean on the Airbus A320, you just push one button and it starts the flight. I know. Like I said before. Oh, that's fine. You can give me a hard time, Aviation. It's all good, my friend. You should. Aviation, on the Airbus A350, you push one button and it starts your flight and your coffee. Hey, I love that. Can it also prepare a bourbon? or a craft beer of choice? Aviation? What? I mean, as soon as it has that capability, I am sold. We'll be flying Airbus the whole time. No more of this Boeing. No more of the CRJ. No more of the Piper Aero. It's all. No, I'm kidding. No, I realize. I don't know. It's like, yeah, if you can fly the 7-3 and get it up in the air, it's far more work than the Airbus. I realize, but it's not the. It's that FMC, the flight management computer differences. It's like, I almost think it's like backwards for me, at least in my brain. It's like backwards, so. Oh, your throttle pack, Con. I gotcha. All right. Stuck in Oakland. Huh. Interesting. Well, you know what, Con? I would guess it's not going to be long you're going to have it. Hopefully it doesn't, you know, get stuck there too long. I mean, I'm in Iowa. I mean, if I'm getting it, you should be getting it, like, I would think quicker than me. Let's see, if it's going from Hong Kong, wouldn't it fly into the West Coast? So I'm surprised I have mine before you. Did you pre-order yours, Con? I assume you did. That's amazing. Maybe something happened there, but hopefully you get it soon, my friend. You should. I think I'm reading in. So, Aces, so what noise does a 747 make when it bounces on landing? I don't know. I could probably tell you. Based on my landings, I'm going to try to do one better tonight. Dude, I'm serious. I've been so used to flying the general aviation aircraft where you pull the throttle out when you're, like, at the threshold and you kind of pitch the nose down. Of course, you're reducing your lift, your angle of attack. So I'm gonna avoid doing that tonight with the big bird here. So I'm hoping we'll land a little softer this time. That's good stuff. Yeah, the auto stop, the auto landing. I don't know. I'm like old school. I wanna land this stuff myself, right? Right, aviation? I mean, come on, you're with me. I saw you how you tried to land on Saba, that fly-in, where you were that close. That close to making it, my friend. You're so close to making it. And there's no way you would have stopped it on that runway. But the fact that you almost made it to the threshold of the runway to land on that island, that was spectacular. That a lot of good laughs out of that one. Boeing, 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 yeah. That's good stuff. Yeah, so for those of you who haven't joined before, welcome. Please smash up the thumbs up button if you like the stream. I do appreciate it. Please subscribe if you would. If you haven't already, I know many of you already have. So that's awesome. I thank you so much for that, SimFans. Sincerely, I do appreciate all of you and you taking your time. We're all busy. I'm sure you're busy. For you to take your time to join the live stream with me is really appreciated for sure. All right, let's check our progress, SimFans. How far out are we here? Looks like we're, from our top of descent, we're at 1933. So let's check that. 1933 Zulu. 1 hour, almost exactly, to our top of descent. So we're making pretty good time, SimFans, really. I've been trying to, like, plan these flights where it's not too short, where they're not too short, but they're also not too long, because I realize all of us, or many of us, maybe not all of us, but many of us have jobs that we got to wake up, or school that we got to wake up for in the morning, so for a Thursday night. Saturday nights, I tend to like to go late. I don't know if that's a good thing, but I do like to go late on Saturday, so. Because we have people, like, in Malaysia and halfway across the world that join in in the mornings, and like, so we're flying at, like, you know, 12:30 a.m. and even 1:30 a.m. and then now all of a sudden you got people jumping on from across the world, which is kind of neat. that is a really good joke, the boing boing boing. Nice one, Aces. I like that. Aces asks, okay, here's an oldie joke. How do you know there's a pilot in the room? How do you know if there's a pilot in the room? They think they know everything? I don't know. What? How do we know, Aces, there's a pilot in the room, my friend? The suspense is killing me. Exactly! I thought maybe that would be the case. Not quite, they know everything. That's awesome. How true? Is that true? It is probably true. That's probably true. That's good stuff. Either that, Aces, or they'll have the big pilot poster behind them, right? On their wall. If they're in your, you know, if you go in their office. Aviation spider, Airbus pilots, look at the ECAM message. All their problems go away. Oh man, that is good. You know, you definitely have the Boeing pilots and the Airbus pilots. And so I didn't know if I was being like sacrilegious when I put that we would be we'd be flying the Boeing 737 tonight and putting the Airbus throttle levers on our Bravo quadrant while flying a Boeing. I thought that might stir the pot a little bit, but so far so good. No major complaints yet. Okay, so Aces Down says, and last one, what's the difference between a pilot and a pepperoni pizza? Pilot and a pepperoni pizza. I give, Aces. I don't know. What is the difference between a pilot and a pepperoni pizza? This will probably be an obvious one, won't it? What is the difference? I am not going to play Lobo Loco. Not because I don't like it. I like it, but it's so long. It's like 15 minutes. Put a little jazz on. I have not heard that one. That's a good one. A pepperoni pizza can feed a family of four. Oh, that's good. Oh, that's good. You know what's funny is like the people that think that pilots make so much money. Unless you're like a senior pilot that's and a captain that's flown like for years with a major airline and you know, then they make some good money, but it's so funny, like the public's like, oh yeah, you be a pilot, you make like, you know, six figures a year, easy. No, you couldn't be more wrong. That's a good one, Aces. Thank you. Thank you for those, Aces. I appreciate those. Kind of a quiet night, but that's all right. I kind of like this laid back atmosphere with all of you. That's why I played a little jazz tunes here. Oh, that was the other thing. I launched, I was going to do active sky for tonight's flight. So notice it's like clear blue skies and standard pressure. Something was going on with active sky. I kept saying wind shear. And I was like sitting on the ground and it wasn't wind shear and it was driving me crazy. So I'm like, nope, turn it off. I was dealing with enough with the X-plane crashing right before the stream, so I'm just like, we're not doing it. So if you're wondering, you're thinking, hey, you know what? That's not the weather where we were at. It's because I have active sky turned off right now. So we're just doing clear skies, and we do need to do some ILS approaches in like IMC conditions for sure. And I know I've talked about that before, and we'll do that maybe this weekend. Maybe Hawaii will have some of the fog roll in from the mountains, depending on what time we fly. That might be a good one to do. Yeah, right. Right, Aces. Aces says, airline captains make a lot of money. Below that, not so much. Yeah, for sure, man. That's so true. So true. I'm shocked, like, Aces, so check this out. They, like, you missed it, and you'll go back, but, like, every single throttle lever had a piece of cellophane plastic wrapped around it. Like, how about you, Aces? Was that the way your Bravo throttle quadrant was? Like, when you received that? Because when I received mine, it was just like you open the box and all the throttle levers are just there. They're not each individually wrapped in plastic. Not that I'm complaining. I love it when there's that extra step of protecting, you know, the stuff that you buy. But I thought that was interesting that they had a piece of plastic on every single one of the throttle levers. I don't know, maybe that way they make you think that you're getting more for your money, right? You spend $70 on a few pieces of plastic. It's pretty expensive for what you get, I admit, but again, I don't have a problem with it just because I kind of frame it within how much do I pay for add-ons and scenery, and this, I can use this all the time forever, so. I guess let's just face it, SimFans. It's a little pricey, but I think it's worth it. I don't know. Maybe it's worth it. Yeah, it's worth it. And I'm not even an Airbus. I'll tell you what. I will submit to all of you right now that I am a Boeing guy. Big surprise. I mean, I like the Airbus, the TOLUS and stuff, but if I had to choose, I'd be flying the 7-3 like we're doing tonight, the 7-5, the 7-6, the 777. I'm not big on the 7-4s. I need to do some more of that, but I do like the Boeing, but go figure. You know, I'm in the U.S., and it's nothing against the European manufacturer of Airbus by any means, but I like Boeing. I've always liked Boeing. And the same holds true for those of you that like Airbus, and there's no problem with that. But I do like the Airbus. I mean, they're fun. They're not, like Aviation Spotter, you say they are easier aircraft to get up and running and go. Alan Cleveland, welcome to the stream, my friend. He says, Aces, you should go take care of the Discord. What's going on in Discord? Alan, welcome to the stream, my friend. Welcome, welcome. Thank you for being here. But yeah, so anyway, to each their own, right? But I'm glad I bought them. I don't regret it. I have them. Now they're an additional piece. I think it's kind of neat that that Honeycomb is doing that, where they're having these add-ons. Kind of neat. Aces, that must be an acquaintance. Aces, are you inviting people to the stream, my friend? If you are, thank you so much. Welcome, Alan. Oh, he got it. That's cool. Welcome, Alan. Thank you for joining us, and yeah, that's awesome. We got this community thing going. It's all good. There's another one! Aviation, what's going on? Aviation Spotter? It's like left and right. I think the traffic global is like just like they're trying to honor you, Aviation Spotter, like by flying closely because you can't. Alan says, I am just watching and learning. Well, welcome. Welcome. Learn with all of us. That's what we're here for. That's what we're here for, my friend.
Hi,
Do I have a favorite engine? Oh, that's a good question. Oh, you know, I do like the General Electric. Does that disappoint? Not the Rolls-Royce Aviation? Yeah, I don't, you know. I mean, the Rolls-Royce obviously is the premium engine, right? You look away, you miss the traffic. Yeah, but, I mean, they're like flying left and right. They're flying right by us. They're like buzzing our cockpit here. It's crazy. Crazy. Ace is down. Says, I think Alan found this one on his own. The other Discord, everybody is sleeping. Yeah, well, hey, that's all good. I mean, we have people stop by, and it's great. It's great. Still 1933, Sim fans. Aviation, don't think about it too hard, Sim fanatic. It's a difficult question. I can't answer. I guess it depends, right? Aviation? I mean, is it, like, which aircraft? I mean, you know, there's all these different models of engines, and because, like, if I was to do the 757, I would probably go with the Rolls-Royce. If it was for the 76 or the 73, I'd probably do General Electric. It's a good question. I don't know. It's a good question. Well, Alan, you know what? I kind of thought your name looked familiar. Have you posted the comments on my video post? Because I thought maybe you had been watched for a while. Hey, thanks for saying something, Alan. It's great to have you in chat, my friend. And I, again, appreciate you following the stream and following the channel. Awesome. Thank you. So, for those of you that are here right now, the first, right? Is it the first? It's the first, right? The first of May. Yeah, 1st of May, Saturday, 8:30 Central Standard Time. We're going to do another fly-in, and we had an absolute ball. Absolute blast. We flew in the Caribbean, and oh my God, that's fun. I mean, I almost debated like we should do that every live stream. I know. But it was so much fun. We had a big showing, and hopefully we'll have as big a showing the next time we do it, because it was a big showing. We had Aviation Spotter, we had Aces Down, we had Kyle, we had Recon Delta. We had a lot of you. I know there was probably like 12 or 13 of us that were flying around that night on a Saturday. So watch for that May 1st. It's a Saturday, 8:30 Central Standard Time, and I haven't decided where we will be flying yet. I'm kind of thinking about like Hawaii for this Saturday, and then maybe something different that we could all do as a group. But maybe we should. What do you think, Aces Aviation Spotter? Anyone else out there? Should we do like maybe I should save Hawaii for the live stream, and for the multiplayer fly-in? What do you think? Let me know. Yeah, I don't know. Let me know what your thoughts are, Sim fans, because I'm open to suggestions. Okay, since we have a little time, give me a couple minutes. I will be right back. I gotta refill my eggnog. Shoot, thank you. Dang it, I did it again. So, Alan, I was just saying, you know, is it on Discord or where do you find the info? I was saying, as you probably couldn't read my lips. So I'll post probably the Tuesday before Saturday, that, you know, like, it'll be 8:30 p.m. Central Standard Time. I'll put that it's East USA server. My gamer tag is Original Mr. Mean. And so you'll be able to check for that. And I'll give, like, each airport that we'll fly to, like where we're taking off from, where we're going to land. And then, like, last stream, I think it was pretty successful. We waited around for about probably 10 minutes for everybody to get connected, make sure everybody was good. And then we took off. And then we kind of circled the airport. We took off from Princess Juliana, TNCM, last time. And then we all flew together. It was great. Check out the stream, Ellen. Yeah, it was a lot of fun. That stream, if you go back in the history and look, it was the 3rd of April. So check back on the 3rd of April. But yeah, so I'll have information well in advance, Alan, for that, so you can connect if you're interested. Thank you. So, I'm surprised you guys are complaining. I mean, I think you probably want me on mute the whole time. I talk too much. Just ask my wife. I talk too much. or anybody that I work with. They probably all wish I had a mute button right about here. Sorry about that. Oh, Alan, thanks for joining the Discord. Hey, we're all nice, Alan. We're all nice. Nobody. That's the thing about this stream. Nobody mean is allowed. That's just it. We're all here to have fun and help each other out, Alan. You bet. Cheers, Alan. Cheers, Aces. Cheers, everybody. Certainly, cheers, Aviation Spotter, and everyone else. I think we lost Captain Maddie. He's probably falling asleep with his. With this 2-year-old. Getting close, Sim fans. Getting close. We're going to have to start entering that descent profile here soon. We'll go through that as usual. I don't know. I kind of like mixing this up with the X-Plane, with the Zibo aircraft, with the FMC. I need to do it with the CRJ, I know, in Microsoft Flight Simulator, but I do like mixing it up with the general aviation. The thing I love about general aviation is it's like, get in, start the airplane, punch in wherever you're going on the GPS, and fly it. I mean, it's so, the pre-flight for that is so much quicker and easier. Yes, Aviation Spotter, even easier than the Airbus, because I know that's coming. But I just love that you can jump into the general aviation aircraft and just go. I mean, just go. Just like in real life. I mean, you do have to pre-flight and you do have to check, you know, all the stuff, but it doesn't take as long. Oh, thank you, Aces, for posting that. Thank you, buddy. Appreciate that. Good job. Thank you. Yeah, check out that. That was a blast. Oh my gosh, that was a blast. I need to go back and index that, by the way, I think. I don't think I ever indexed that. Did I index that, Aces? For like the highlights, I should index that, so it's like, well, we landed at this airport, then landed at this airport. Here's where Aviation Spotter crashed and burned before he landed at Saba. here's where Aces Down took off, and I don't remember. You had problems from Saba too, Aces, didn't you? If I remember correctly, seemed like you were. I don't remember. Did you crash? I don't remember. I don't think you crashed, but you had some sort of trouble with your airplane, if I remember right. But that was so, oh god, that was fun. You guys are all crazy too. But you know what was impressive to me? It's like, I've seen a lot of live streams with multiplayer sessions. And, you know, of course, you know, I mean, granted, I mean, there was 13 of us, but I mean, everybody I don't even want to say for the most part. Everybody knew what they were doing. So I kind of felt, I don't know, that was a little bit, I don't know. It was kind of like, it's kind of like complimentary, if you will. It's just like, okay, so the, not that it has to be that way, so don't get me wrong. I mean, if you're here and you're just, you want to try flying this May 1st, I mean, if you're not good at simming, don't worry about it. But it was just, it was pretty impressive, the fact that everybody was like flying level and together. But don't, you know, if you're here and you're not that well versed in flight simming, it's okay. It's not a problem. But I was just really impressed with the first multiplayer fly-in live stream. How many of you were doing very well in flying formation? That was impressive. So, a couple things. So, Ace is down, says, no, you didn't index, and yes, I did crash. Oh, that's right, you hit the boulder, I forgot. That's right, there's that boulder that you crashed into. Oops, ouch. And then Alan says, Ace is usually flies in the back, so you can't see him when he crashes. Oh, that's good stuff, that's good stuff. No, that was so much fun, though. I forgot, though, Aces. Yeah, it wasn't like the boulder was pretty close to the threshold of the runway, wasn't it? It's like, why would they not move that boulder, if I remember right? That's me, Sam. Well, okay. Well, Alan, it's all good, man. No worries. No worries. So do check that out. May 1st, we're going to do a fly-in, and we're going to be together, and it's going to be a blast. It's going to be... And you know what? Get on the, you know, the stream, and we'll show the world your flying skills, right? We'll get you out there in the public eye. Don't make that scare you. It's good. And Aces or Aviation Spotter, one of you have to remind me to put on the name tags, because I didn't do that until, like, I don't know, it was probably like 2/3 of the way or later in the stream. I want to turn those on so everybody knows who is where. So help me out, guys, to remember to turn that on. I'll try to remember to turn that on, but I want to make sure I have the nameplates on. So while we're streaming live, everybody can see where they're at, because we all want to see where we're at and along with everyone else. So. Alan, he knows his stuff, though. Yes, he does. You're absolutely right, Alan. Yeah, Ace is down as a real pilot, and he does knows his stuff. Agreed, he does. Let's see, Aviation Spotter. I had winds up, and I'm not sure what it's called, but there was something over that little mountain that slammed my aircraft into the ground. Oh, that was I was impressed. Aviation, I was impressed, because, I mean, you came damn close, my friend, to landing that thing. I mean, for you to try to land it, you're definitely good at this. No doubt about it. No doubt about it. You definitely know what you're doing. But, I mean, you were that close, and, I mean, that's a short runway. I mean, I had it easy. I was flying the Piper Arrow. Anybody could land the Piper Arrow on that thing. But you were trying to land a CRJ-700 on it, and you damn near did it. Yeah. Okay, so notice the... this is something that I got to... There's an add-in for the... See how the... Just basically the shadow... It's all like jagged and stuff. There's a fix for that, and I did have it before, but it's I don't know. Apparently, it isn't working with 11.5.3, so I need to find an updated plugin for that. All right, we probably should start start setting up for our descent profile. So let's go ahead and do that, SimFans. So if you've never done this before, I'm going to show you how you do this with the Zibo or any aircraft for that matter. And if you've done it a million times, you're fine with it, I know, because you'll just bear with me as we go through this, okay? So to do it, it's pretty easy, actually. It's really not that hard. It looks a little bit like overwhelming at first when you start looking at this stuff, but it really isn't that bad. Trust me. Trust me. If I can do it, you can do it. So, as you noticed before, that was when I was programming the FMC. The one thing that we're going to look at here is ignore that 26. We're actually going to be landing 8 ILS. So, let's turn that off for a moment. We'll get back to that. And we'll go to Chrome. And we're going to take a look. Where'd it go? Hold on. I lost it. I don't know why it's not showing up. Hold on. There we go. Okay. So, you want to get your chart, and I already loaded it, but see, airnav.com, check it out if you haven't already. It's free, and you can get, and this is for the U.S. It does not include the European or other world airports, so you got to go other sites for that. But what we're going to look at is runway 8. So we download that, and then here's our approach plate for ILS, instrument landing system, for localizer for runway 8. And we're going to go over this on some key pieces. And so bear with me, because I do want to show this. But so the biggest thing to note is this 6300 and this little lightning bolt. That's our ILS intercept. That's our glide slope. So that's when the aircraft instrument landing system is going to, autopilot's going to take over and start descending at a proper 3 degree, 4 degree glide slope down to the runway, where you don't have to do anything. You don't have to even touch anything, and it'll just glide you down. And then typically you can disable your autopilot at like 1500 feet, maybe 1000 feet above ground level, and then fly it in. But so that's a key thing though, that's 6300. I'm gonna quiz all of you in a minute here, so remember that. Up here we have 111.9. Now that is the nav frequency that we gotta program into our nav comms, and we're gonna do that. And then the other important piece is this course at 79. So you can see it there, and you can see it here. There's that 79, okay? So remember, there's only really, truly, honestly, for flight simming anyway, not real life, but for flight simming, there's those three things to remember. Your intercept, your frequency for your nav computer, and your course. Just remember that. These charts are so overwhelming that it's just like, there's so much information. Don't get lost in that, SimFans. Trust me. Trust me. Don't get lost in that. You can do this. You can fly this. So what we're going to do is we're going to flip over to our aircraft. And so the first thing, if you remember, we had a course of 79. So all we're going to do is we're just going to go up here and we're going to change. We have two course dials. And by the way, I can do that on the Bravo Throttle Quadrant, but I'm going to just do it here because it's easier. So we do 79 there, and we do 79 on our first officer's dial there. So we got 79, 79. Okay, that's one of three things, right? One of three things we got accomplished so far. Now the next thing, we need to dial in. Remember what that was, 111.9. And here's another tip for you sim fans. If you go to your FMC, hit this INET reference. Click that. Frank House! Welcome, Frank. Hello, sir. I was late. Sorry. No problems, Frank. I was hoping you'd join us. Frank, we're thinking this for the first. I was trying to debate this Saturday if we would do Hawaii, Frank, because you mentioned flying in Hawaii. So either we're going to do Hawaii on the live stream this coming Saturday, Frank, or we're going to do the fly-in at Hawaii, and we're going to do some island hopping. So I'm going to try to decide what we want to do there. But anyway, back to programming this. So we see 111.9, and notice it says ILS 8 course 79. So there's the 79 we programmed in, and there's 111.9. Now, that's the same. So sometimes those are off, but I subscribe to a subscription that's Navigraph, and it is a monthly subscription, and I do a year subscription to it, so I get all the latest approach plates and everything like that, and I actually download them to the FMS for X-Plane. Microsoft Flight Simulator actually, I think, has those updated. Correct me if I'm wrong, sim fans, but X-Plane, you actually have to pay for the service to get the latest approach plates, and that's when you're going off of AirNav, that's what you're getting. Okay, so anyway, so now we got to dial in 111.9. So we're just going to simply go down here to our nav computer. So here we got to dial in. So I'm going to switch that because it already has 111 there. So now all I got to do is dial that up to 111.9. So we're going to do that. And then we got to do this transfer. So the screen on the left is the one that's actually active. The one on here is on standby, right? Just says right up there. So make sure you have your nav frequency for your ILS approach in the active, okay? So we're gonna do the same thing over here. So now we got 111.9. Okay, there's two of three. Okay, quiz time, sim fans. What's the last thing I need to remember to do? Anyone wanna take a guess? We talked about this before. What else do we need to make sure we do? What's the third thing that we need to make sure before we hit our top of descent profile? And again, our top of descent profile, if we hit progress right here, we'll see it's at 1933. We're 150 nautical miles away from our top of descent. That's a big clue. What do we need to make sure we do, sim fans, before we hit top of descent? And don't leave if you don't want to answer. It's okay if you don't know. Oh, somebody responded here. Okay. Alan Cleveland asks, is there a max and a minimum above and below the 6300 intercept? Yes, that's a good question, Alan. There is. There's something that's called minimum. And so minimum's not at the intercept. There's not. But there is a minimum. So we can get back to that if you want, and we can talk about that. And that'll depend if you're on a Category 3, 2, or 1 on an ILS approach, and there's something called minimums. And so we'll call that an intermediate level. Maybe we'll cover that another time, but that's a great question, Alan. Great question. Aces Down says, at or above 63 is typical. A line under the altitude means a not go below. A line over the number says don't go above 6300. If a line under and over, then must be at 6300, not above. So yes, remove autopilot and wing. Remove AP and wing. I'm not sure what that means, but anyway. So, but what, I'm still looking for an answer here. So what do we need to do before we hit our top of descent? And by the way, I'll scroll out. Am I talking too loud? I feel like I'm talking loud. So here, let's do this. See this TD right here, that TD? That's the thing that stands for top of descent. So we got to do, of the three things that we've done so far. So we set our course at 79 on both our left and right. So here and here, that was important, right? And again, let's go back. So again, we have our 79 course line highlighted right there. So we got that plugged in. We also have our 111.9 plugged into our nav 1 and nav 2 comm. Or navigation, rather. But what's the last thing we need to remember to do? Alan, wing it. Okay, I'm a little slow. I get it. Wing it. Yeah, you could wing it. And sometimes I do wing it, for sure. Sometimes I do wing it, Alan. Frank Rose, let me ask you something. This is off topic. Have you ever seen the Qantas safety video? I think it's one of the best in my opinion. I haven't. Might have to check that out, Frank. The Qantas safety video. Frank, do you want to put a link in chat and then we can all check it out? I'll definitely check it out if you have a link for it, Frank. Aces, you got it. You got it, my friend. Sorry about that, Alan. I got you, finally. I'm a bit slow, but yeah, I got it. So yeah, wing it. But Aces, you actually got it. Set altitude to descend to. So we need to set the altitude to 6300. So that's the intercept. So we're just going to go up here, and we're going to set this to 6300. And that's it. So that's important, right? So before you get to this top of descent that's in green, you gotta make sure that this is lower than your cruising altitude. So it wouldn't matter if I had it at, if we had it at 35,000 feet, it would still start descending, but it'd only go to 35,000. So what I always do is I plug in the intercept for that ILS approach. And don't worry, if you're in mountainous terrain, your FMC, if we take a look at that, if we look at our FMC, notice this on the right here, it says flight level 280, that's 28,000, 16,168. So don't worry about like flying into any mountains, because your flight managed computer, even though we set it at 6,300, it's not gonna go below these, at these intersection SimFans. So as we're, if we go back to legs, as we're going back, going by these, and let's take a look at our map. Let me zoom out a little bit here. But as we're going by, oh God, that looks terrible. It's so, yeah, it's all together. But as we're going over those, our autopilot system and our flight management computer is smart enough to keep us at safe levels. Oh God. There we go. Sorry about that. Thank you. No, so what I was saying is, if we look at the, so we have this flight level 350, flight level 280, 16,168, 16,000. So don't worry about setting it at 6,300. As we can see here, if we go to Giselle, that's at 6,300. Our flight management computer is going to keep us at those safe altitudes. And it's just going to step us down to each altitude before we land as we're approaching across these intersections. So, yeah. Sorry, but I always forget that because I switch. So, like, if I put those screens up and then I switch to my actual flight simulator, I'm not in ABS, I don't see what you're seeing. So, I apologize. You are welcome. You are welcome, Alan. Thank you. Thank you guys for letting me know that I was leaving that stuff over and you couldn't see. I'll learn eventually. But, so anyway, hopefully that helps. Is that helpful? I don't know. Does it make sense? Does it make sense, Alan? Does it make sense, Frank? Does it make sense, Aces? Does that make sense, Aviation? Hopefully I'm doing an okay job explaining that. But, you know, it's easy to get overwhelmed by all the stuff that's there. Let me talk about minimums for a second, because Alan, you asked. Now, I'll try not to forget I have that damn thing up, right? So here we see category SILS 8. So here's your minimum. So you can go down to 5,527 feet, and now that's mean sea level, right? So that's where you're going to want to pay attention to your altimeter. And if you can't see the runway lights, then that means you need to do a go around at that altitude. And so you think, well, that's pretty high. Well, keep in mind that Albuquerque is pretty high altitude. I think we're at like right up here. We're at 5,355 in mean sea level. So you got to keep that in mind. So really, when you look at that, that's actually not that high above the ground. And then this here is localizer. So that's just running on the localizer. That isn't going to give your glide slope information, so it's going to be higher. So notice here, it's essentially 200 feet higher. That is your minimum, because you don't have the instrument landing system that's giving your glide slope information. It's keeping you left and right straight. It's keeping you along the runway, but in terms of your vertical distance from the ground, it's not keeping that as accurate. So those are those minimums that you want to account for. So when you're landing and it's like completely foggy or cloudy and you're popping out, then it's like all of a sudden, boom, there's the runway and the runway lights, right? Yeah. Okay, thanks, Aces. Makes sense. All right, good deal. Cheers. Yeah, Alan, he will. He'll probably have a video on all of it. Does a good job with that. Do check out Aces Down, SimFans. Check out Aces Down One site. I do have a link to his channel. below or on my channel. He's a real world pilot like myself, he does a little more in depth. I kind of cover the highlights. I'm trying to find like a middle ground between, you know, real world pilot in aviation to like I'm just here to have fun and sim. I'm trying to hit that middle ground where ACES is really looking at getting more of the real. If you're interested in how it's done in the real world, check out his site because he goes through that. So yeah, and he doesn't leave like that the freaking approach plates over to the screen when he's doing it. Of course, I am live streaming, so but you guys keep me in line, so it's all good, and I appreciate it. Got to move my chair forward. All right, some fans. Well, hopefully that helps. I don't know. I kind of like just giving just the gist of getting you enough information to get to what you need to get done to land a plane safely and not have to worry about studying for, you know, 4 or 5 hours on how to interpret something and memorization and all that. Not that takes that, but it's pretty you can get as detailed and nerdy with it as you want, which, by the way, I'm a nerd at heart, so I'm all for it, but I realize that many of you are here to have fun, and you don't necessarily want to know every single detail, and that's awesome. That's cool. There's a happy medium, in my opinion. That's kind of where I'm driving my content. Okay, thanks, Alan. Appreciate the feedback, Aces. Slowly but getting there. Yeah. Well, no, you're getting there, man. You're definitely getting there. It's good stuff. I enjoy it. I enjoy the fact, Aces, that you're down. You're just what you see is what you get. Real world and casual and stuff like that. That's all good. We're getting close to that top of descent, Sim fans. Getting close. Getting really close. Our tunes disappeared, didn't they? Guess we're done with the jazz. Right? Oh, no. Oh, Recon Delta, what the hell? Recon Delta, welcome to the stream. You are insane, my friend. Thank you so much. Recon Delta. You're too kind, my friend. You're too kind. Recon Delta says, beer fun for the stream. I'm late for the stream. Sorry, Symfanatic. I'll be offline for a week and a half or two. Helping daughter move out of her 4K... square foot house? Holy crap! That's big! Into a smaller home. LOL to other Sim fans, help support this fanatic. Thank you, Recon Delta and all of you. I can't thank you enough. Thank you so much, Recon Delta. That is really not necessary, but I appreciate it so much, my friend. Thank you so much. And as I've mentioned, I will put all donations back into either hardware like we reviewed. By the way, Recon Delta, we did the unboxing, so you gotta like skip back and find the live stream unboxing of the Honeycomb Airbus Throttle Pack. We unboxed that earlier tonight in the stream, so do check that out. But I will put all the money donated to me, not in my pocket. I appreciate the beer fund. I do, Recon, because as you know, I'm a craft beer fan. But I will put the money that Recon Delta and the rest of you that have donated back into the sim and back to all of you, either in reviews or giveaways, what have you. That is my promise to all of you, because I do want to give back. That's what this channel's about. Thank you, Recon Delta, so much. Thank you. Thank you, my friend. Blue skies. Yeah, right. So, Al in Cleveland, I gotta get caught up here. Wait a minute. So So, okay, so Captain Maddie, what'd you do? We, like, lost you for a while there, Captain Maddie. I'm sure you're probably putting Josiah to bed, if I were to guess. Captain Maddie said you did explain it good enough. Okay, you were here watching. You're just being quiet. That's cool. Frank Rose, sorry, I didn't. No, that's all right. Alan, Pink Floyd, if you're gonna play music. So, you know, Alan, I wish I could, man. I wish I could, but as Aces Down said, copyrights. This stream will be ixnayed if I did Pink Floyd or any other copyrighted material. So that's why I have the music listed below. This is royalty free. I'd be playing all kinds of good music. I mean, this is good too, mind you. But Frank Rose, sorry, I don't know how to drop a link to watch Qantas. No worries, Frank. We'll find it. Aces, go find that. I know you can find that, Aces. So Frank said the Qantas safety video. It's got to be out there somewhere. It might be on YouTube, but it might be out on the web somewhere. But no worries, Frank. Appreciate the recommendation. Again, Recon, you are too nice, my friend. All of you are too nice. Thank you so much. Appreciate that so much. Yeah, no, Frank, we appreciate that tip, because we'll check that out. You know what I might do, Frank? I might have to do a Qantas flight and put that safety. So some of you have probably watched the stream when I did PAX, and you can actually put your safety audio, so it's a WAV file. You just capture it and put it, and you can have it in your own aircraft. I think I've showed that in a live stream somewhere. But it's pretty cool. PAX is pretty cool. And you can use PAX, by the way, SimFans. What is PAX? What's PAX, Darren? Come on, talk to me, SimFanatic, right? So it simulates your passengers when you're on, like, these aircraft, and they, like, show little dots roaming around, and they sit on seats, and they tell you how good they're enjoying the flight. But then they have, the cabin announcements and the safety videos and all that. Although what I like about the Zibo is it's all included. Speaking of which, we never did our cruise altitude announcement, did we? Okay, hold on. I'm going to pause this for a second, because we're going to do our safety, our welcome to the flight, ladies and gentlemen. So we'll go to PA system. There's a welcome, but we did level off, so let's go ahead and listen.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. So we're leveled to our initial cruise altitude, expecting a fairly smooth ride today. We have the seatbelt sign turned off, and while you're seated, we do ask that you keep your seatbelt fast about you at all times in case of encounter unexpected bumpy air. And we do thank you for flying with us on American.
So yeah, so the Zibo is kind of nice because it has that stuff built in, which is kind of cool. Yeah, Frank, 100 years of Qantas for sure on YouTube. It might be hard to find. But thanks for that tip. We're getting awfully close, some fans. We're going to have to drop our distance down a little bit here. Okay, so I think Ace has found it. Okay, Aces, I knew Aces would find it. So Aces will post it here. I'll have to check that out. Now, when I was programming the FMC earlier, SimFans, it was saying that there's going to be a steep decline after one of the waypoints. So help me out with that, would you? Because we might have to throw the air brake in. I don't know. Maybe we should be doing that now. We don't need to do that now. We're not descending yet. But I heard a ding. So what was that? Okay, we're good on the FMC. Look at this. Look at these mountaintops with the... look at that. Beautiful Ortho 4XP, SimFans. It's all free. If you fly X-Plane... You need, if you haven't already, to check out Ortho4XP. You're going to need some disk space, and you're going to need an ISP that doesn't have a cap on your data, on your download, I used to have a cap at 2 terabytes, and I would just like do about a terabyte every month and get all this scenery, but looks it absolutely looks as good as Microsoft Flight Simulator at 36,000 feet, as you can see, as you can tell. Definitely worth it. Definitely worth it. I mean, look at that. Isn't that beautiful? So good. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. So, you know, what kind of music do you all like? I mean, Pink Floyd. Alan, you like Pink Floyd? I like their old stuff. I mean, to be honest, I don't like their new stuff, but I like their old stuff, some of it. I'm a drummer. I'm real life drummer. Play the skins, if you will, and actually played with a band, a cover band, but we opened for a few like 80s rock bands, well-known rock bands. That was kind of a neat experience. I talked about that before. I won't bore you with the details now. But I do play the drums, and I'm not a big 80s fan. My wife is. She loves 80s music. I detest it. 80s music. I'm sorry. So those of you that like 80s music, don't unsubscribe. Don't smash the thumbs down button. It's fine. I mean, I played 80s music in a cover band for a while. So don't hold it against me that I don't like 80s music. I like 70s music. Love 70s, some 70s classical rock and 90s the grunge era, the Seattle bands. Love that stuff. All right, we'll see you back. Aces, thank you for posting the Qantas safety video. Frank, I will capture that for a future stream. So we'll have that play. I'll run PAC-X like I was talking about. And we'll do a Qantas flight. We'll fly Australia somewhere. So we'll do that, Frank. Thanks for posting that, or for recommending that. Alan says, yeah, leave the view outside. Inside the cockpit scares me. Hey, you know what, Alan? Have you ever been in a general aviation aircraft for real? I'll tell you what, if you want to be scared, jump into one of those. It's unlike anything you've ever been in. You want to talk about scary, you're front and center. Yeah. Yeah, hobby is a lot of fun. This sim flying is a great hobby. I've done it all my life. I have. I mean, all the way back to Sublogic with the wire mesh buildings and like only a few airports that you actually saw buildings at. So, yeah, not to date myself, but I've been doing this for a long, long time. And I'm just super excited that all of you are into it and either have been into it for years or getting into it now. It's all good. What do you guys think about Honeycomb and Xbox Series X and Microsoft Nosobo releasing it for the Xbox Series X? Microsoft Flight Simulator, I mean. What are your thoughts on that? Put it in chat. Don't be shy. Let's talk about it. I've got my thoughts. You probably already know them if you've been following me, but what are your thoughts on that? You have concerns or you think it's a good thing? Talk to me, Goose. All right, Sim fans, so here we go. So as you can see, we're descending. We hit that top of descent. And because we have, we go to here. Since we have our altitude selector at 6,300 feet, that's why we're descending, right? If that was still set at 36,000 like it originally was, we'd go right by that top of descent point and we would not be decreasing altitude right now. We still have a ways to go, but wanted to point that out. So our estimated time at the gate is 1951 Zulu, Sim fans. It's only 77 nautical miles away. So we're really close. I don't think we're 15 minutes close. We're farther away than 15 minutes. That's time of touchdown, probably. Alan says, I'm too new to comment on that. That's all right. Asa says, missed the question. Frank, I am excited to watch Top Gun 2. When is that coming out? Because they can't... Well, I mean, it was supposed to already be out, but with the COVID stuff and, you know, Hollywood, all that stuff has been, like, postponed. So, when is Top Gun 2 coming out? What? Recon Delta. So, Recon Delta, you said, I've had my Honeycomb Bravo on order since December last year and still on back order. Recon, I think you told me this before. Where did you buy it from? You didn't buy it from Honeycomb Direct, did you? You bought it from reseller, didn't you? Correct me if I'm wrong, Recon. Where'd who go? December 21st. Wow, that seems like a long... Well, that's a long ways away, Frank. But yeah, Frank, I'm excited to see it. How about you? Are you looking forward to it? I assume so, since you asked. That'd be weird, though. You know, like, I don't know. You know, like those sequels for something that's really good? It's, you know, so let's talk about the sequels that have really been good in the history of film. So, some of you might argue, I don't know. I kind of back and forth on this. But The Godfather, you know, with maybe exception. Another sequel, Star Wars, of course. That sequel, I think, is like by bar none. You know, episodes 4, 5, and 6, bar none. They're great. 1, 2, and 3. The third Star Wars was good. First and second was pretty much crap, in my opinion. And then the final three, oh, man. I thought The Force Awakens was good. The second one was atrocious. And I thought the third one... A lot of people didn't like the third one. I actually liked the third one. The ninth one. I did four. Ninth. What other sequels have been good? Lord of the Rings. If you're a Lord of the Rings fan, Lord of the Rings was good, right? We can't deny that fact. Lord of the Rings was a great, great trilogy. Yeah, what else? There's been so many that haven't been good. I don't know, Frank. I'm hopeful, though. I'm hopeful Top Gun 2 will be good. It seems like if there's a trilogy, they're usually pretty good. Indiana Jones, there's another one. Just came to mind. I mean, who doesn't like Raiders of the Lost Ark? And then Temple of Doom, not bad, but so-so. But Last Crusade with Sean Connery, you gotta love that one, right? Okay, Recon, reseller. Yeah, see, man, I mean, are they giving you any updates, like, when you're going to get it, my friend? Are they telling you when you're going to get your Bravo Quadrant? Because you need it. You need it yesterday. Keep us posted, Recon. I hope you get it soon, my friend. Ace is down, says, November 19th, 2021, last I knew for a TG2 release. Yeah, December, that seems so late. And Captain Maddie says, I have been hooked to see Top Gun 2. I hope it's not going to be lame, right? I mean, that's speaking the obvious, but I don't know. I could see it being lame. How many of you, like, have you ever seen Iron Eagle? Like, just it's really a cheesy 80s music. Or 80s music. It's an 80s film, but it's about as cheesy as 80s music. But it's actually good. Lou Scassa Jr., and I can't remember the actor's name that's Doug on it. Dougie. It's really kind of cheesy, but it's a great movie. I've seen it a million times. I love the fact that it's like one F-16 going in and taking out like an entire Air Force for a nation with only the ordnance of one aircraft that can hold and the fuel one aircraft can hold. It's so far-fetched. But it's still fun. It's a fun movie. But then they did Top Gun, or not Top Gun, they did Iron Eagle 2, and it was so bad. And wasn't there an Iron Eagle 3 as well? Am I alone here? Who else has seen Iron Eagle? Tell me there's somebody else out there that's seen Iron Eagle and likes it. And don't be shy. It was good. Or here's another one, Sim fans. Flight of the Intruder. How many of you seen Flight of the Intruder? Again, I don't main actor, I don't really call his name, but the supporting actor, he was in Platoon. Who was that? Damn, I'm just drawing a blank with name. I'm never good with names as it is, but I'm drawing a blank. William Dafoe, right? Wasn't William Dafoe, if I got that right? But, and I'm not doing searches. It's coming to me. But yeah, Flight of the Intruder wasn't a bad flick, if you want to see that. What other flicks, Sim fans? Aviation flicks. We need to talk about this. This is good to talk about. What else have we had out there that we like? As we're coming into Albuquerque. Why are we banked? Are we? Oh, we're turning. Okay, good. All right, let's hit the standard. I need to start thinking about our approach here. I'm talking too much. All right, let's get this switched over here to... So switch this to approach. So you're gonna have your VOR and your ILS, and I leave this so I can see my map on the left. So I leave my left MFC. I leave that at map, and then I turn my right one to approach. So then I can see when I intercept the ILS. It's a quick tip for you if you didn't know. And we're decreasing, so it looks like we're doing pretty good. I don't know. What do you think, SimFan? Should we like? It's gonna be a pretty sharp. I hate these hairpin turns. That's not horrible. Let's wing it. Like Alan said, just wing it, right, Alan? Just wing it. Willem Dafoe. Yeah, he was good, wasn't he, in that? God, yeah, he was good in that. Yeah, so Asa says, oh yes, loved Iron Eagle. Sequels weren't so good though. Yeah, I agree. My favorite was the first one, he's flying a Cessna. Oh yeah, that's right! Oh, and don't you like Ace's when, like, the guy's buddy is in the aircraft? He's like, what did you do, you creep? And he's like, somebody made me do it. He made me loosen the oil cap. It's like, spill your guts just because. Oh, but that's 80s action for you, right? It's so funny. So cheesy, but yeah, good. We gotta have fun with the cheesy 80s flicks, right? Yeah, Willem Dafoe. You're right, Willem Dafoe. I said William. Willem Dafoe. Alan Cleveland, you land that thing soon. My wine glass contents are dwindling. All right. Well, I will aims to please. Zachary Laramie, hello. Welcome to the stream, Zachary. Welcome, welcome. Thank you for joining us, SimFan. Appreciate you joining us tonight. Welcome, welcome. The flight attendant, yeah, exactly, Alan. So like Asa said, the flight attendant will be with you shortly. She will refill your wine glass. Soon, my friend, soon. We aims to please on American Airlines. Who's good with Photoshop? I mean, I'm okay, but I'm not like super good. We need to get a SimFans livery, don't we? We need to get a livery that says SimFans on it, I think. Might have to work on that. That might be fun. Or SimFanatic, SimFans, something. I don't know. Whoever's good with like Photoshop, PSDs, we might need something like that. I don't know. All right, we need to like zoom in here. Let's zoom in a little bit more. I think we'll be okay, hopefully. Oh no, some fans. Okay, let's get our pre-landing. So I'm gonna put this on max. We're banking to the right, and that made me a little nervous because I'm like, what's going on? Okay, let's get our landing lights back on. We're about under 10,000. Usually you put the landing lights on under 10,000, right? We got our auto brakes set. And our ILS frequency's in, our ILS course is in. Our heading, yeah, we probably should put our heading in, shouldn't we? So we're landing on runway 8, so let's get that at 8, or 7-9, rather. So everything's in sync. Our altimeter set, landing lights, wing lights. Oh yeah, we need to get our wing lights on. So let's get our wing lights on. Wing lights, well lights, landing lights. Didn't I get those turned on? There we go, landing lights are on. We need our runway turn lights on as well. So let's take a flyby. So there's our, all of our lights. Our lights are on, sim fans, we're ready to go. We're ready for this landing. Let's see if I can nail this landing. I have been doing an absolute horrible, horrible time landing this 737 the last few times because I'm going to make excuses here, I realize, but I've been so used to the general aviation aircraft where you cut it out early and you just don't do that with these. So I got to get back into my sink here. Aviation spotter, let's see, okay, Zachary. Oh, Captain Maddie, see you, buddy. Thank you for coming. He says he's got to go. Great stream. Thank you, Captain Maddie, as always, for joining. Appreciate it. Have fun with Josiah. I'm glad you both were able to make it tonight, Captain Maddie. Thank you so much for joining. Blue skies to you. Zachary, you say, I wish that Throttle Quadrant was in stock again. I can't wait to get it. Yeah, I know, man. As Recon Delta's mentioned, he pre-ordered, and he's still waiting for that thing. Aviation spotter, I'm going to need an extra seatbelt. And okay, I'm going to prove you wrong tonight. Aviation spotter, I'm going to land this sucker so smoothly. I'm going to make you eat that comment. Now I said that, the pressure's on. I am under heat now. I realize I shouldn't have said that.
2500.
Ace is down, says making livery is harder than just photoshopping a pic. Yeah, right? Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'm going to need some help. Let's put flaps down. And look at that! It worked! Like I was saying, last time, every time I put the flaps down, the auto throttle disengaged, but I found a solution to that. So let me know if you want to know what that solution is. Alan says, put your landing gear down! And just in case you forgot, like I do most of the time. I usually throw that down, Alan, when I approach the intercept. But yeah, no, thank you for reminding me, though. I can use all the help I can get from all of you. We're going to put a little bit of the speed brake. This is a pretty aggressive descent here, sim fans. We are... Okay, now we're going to hit approach mode, okay? So now when we're getting close, because we got this dialed in, look at our ILS. So we're going to hit approach. So now we got our approach locked in. So as soon as we intercept the ILS, our aircraft, like it's doing now, it's going to start gliding in. And does anyone remember what our intercept... what is our intercept called? Anybody remember? We're gonna throw the landing gear down. Notice that I gotta do it twice. Now it's going down. Here it comes. All right, let's see if I can't mess this up. Now, see, why did I do that? I said that and I put the pressure on me because like I told Aviation Spotter I was going to make him eat his words because he's been with me the last few times I've landed this thing and it's been anything but smooth. I haven't blown any tires yet, amazingly, but it has not been great. All right, let's, actually, one thing we want to go to is this initial ref. So I had 5 knots to that, so we're going to go 147. So 147, so I'm going to drop that down to 147, and we're going to keep continuing to drop our flaps. I don't know why that, so now that's kicking off my autopilot, and it just messed me up. Screw it. All right, here we go. So it's all manual landing now, sim fans. This isn't looking so good. Seems like we have a little bit of a crosswind. Glide slope. Yeah, well, whatever. That seems off to me. Turn that auto throttle off.
100.
Take rate.
50.
40.
Oh, God.
20. 10.
Oh, I didn't do so well. I really need to practice this, SimFans. We're gonna go around. Wow, that was like even worse yet. I shouldn't have said anything. All right, we're going around. That was terrible. I don't know what my problem is. Probably part of my problem was I had speed brake on.
400.
And that was a bad approach. Gotta put the flaps up. Let's go 5.
Take a moment to check your seat.
That's hilarious. Okay, aviation spotter, it's a good thing you had, like... Oh, how embarrassing. This is terrible. I mean, even though that was an aggressive approach... God, I've lost my mojo when it comes to landing this thing. What my deal is. Yeah, boing, boing, boing. Oh, we'll watch that on a replay, SimFans. No doubt about it. We're going to have fun with SimFanatic tonight and making fun of him for his horrible descent. Oh, my God. How bad was that? Oh my God. I am clearly out of practice with the Zibo SimFans. I've gotten too comfortable with general aviation that it's just like I am not doing well on the approaches with this. Zachary, I've done lower nose before. That's why I was trying that for a change, but I don't know what my deal is. I've just not been good about landing this plane. I usually would land it like super smooth, and like lately, I've been really bad at it for some reason. I don't know what the deal is. I have no excuse. I wish I had a good excuse, but I really don't have a good excuse. Yeah, I thought I would stall too, but I got out of that fortunately. Welcome back, Captain Maddie. You just missed a horrible landing. We had to do a go-around because it really did not look good. And we're going to make fun of me as soon as I'm done. If I ever do get done landing and I get us safely on the ground. SimFans, what was the altitude of this? It's 5,400, so 6,400. So we're way too high. Well, not really. It depends on what our approach is here. We're going to try this again. God! Oh my goodness, so bad. Go ahead, have fun. Make fun of me if you will. It's fine. I've got broad shoulders. Turboprop for me. Yeah, no kidding. No kidding, Alan. Recon Delta says I see people on the ground laughing. What is my deal, SimFans? I seriously have never been. You aren't going to believe me, I know. But check out some of my streams. I have some older streams landing this very aircraft, and it's like butter. And I don't know what the hell is wrong with me lately. That's us. No, it's not, Aces. You're on the airplane with me. You're not on the ground. ABQ, 8,000 above. Yeah, okay. You know what, right? So whatever happens, I am going to try to stick it at this point. So what may be. So get ready for even more laughs, because if I don't stick this one, SimFans. Oh, yeah, Captain Maddie, I appreciate that. But I have not... I have had major problems with landing this one lately. And I don't... Here's our circle. I don't know what my problem is. I've definitely got to practice. I think that much is clear, SimFans. That much is clear. All right, let's go ahead and bank. God, Well, we're going to intercept the ILS again. I think another thing that threw me off is, like, when I hit my track IR button, it disabled my autopilot. And I wasn't really prepared for that. I just overflew our intercept, but that's okay. What do you think the passengers are thinking right now? Like, oh my god, get us off this flight. I mean, they've got to be thinking, this pilot is crazy and we're going to die. Yes. See, I knew I shouldn't have said I was going to stick that landing, because I set myself up for failure for sure. Gonna put some yep, this is gonna be crazy. This is crazy. Yeah, we're gonna do a visual, Zachary, for sure. We're gonna actually side slip. Let's just do something stupid. Oop, 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 oop. All right. They are all throwing up. Oh my god. And we're way above. This is not going to be good. This is a horrible approach, because I'm doing a visual landing. Yeah. Thank you for the landing gear. Yep. All right.
2500.
That is what you call winging it. Aviation, Alan, an aviation spotter, for sure. For sure winging this. Like, literally, right? God. I don't know. You know what? Maybe there's got to be an update, right? Maybe there was an update that made it more difficult. What do you think? What do you think, guys? Was it, you think it's an update? Maybe there's like an update that made it more difficult to land this? The Zibo?
Feet stabilized, Mr. Bridge altitude 7.
Flight slow.
This is what happened last time, and I really messed it up.
Flight slow.
500. 400.
Flight slow. 300.
Flight slow.
Terrain.
Pull up. Something's wrong there. My contact's going
100. 50, 40, 30, 20, 10.
Reversers. Keep that nose up. A little bit better. Floated a bit. That's better though.
80.
Put the reversers off. Whew, we made it. Oh, Jesus. Oh, my God. We made it. See, I got you guys back. I got you back alive. Oh, I need to practice this Boeing. Nothing like doing this live stream where you can't edit anything. Nor would I, because that's half the fun. All right, Sim fans, I got you back alive. And all of you are still laughing at me, which you should be. I see you on the tarmac. Thank you, Alan. Thank you, Aces. Recon, appreciate you, like, boosting my ego, because that first landing, I needed it. I needed you guys to boost my ego there, because that was horrible. Let's get this bird up to the gates here, my friends. And we'll just, yeah. Oh my gosh, was that not crazy, though? Wow. Second time around. That's what it takes. You know, like, at least it wasn't like third time's a charm, right? Like, sometimes they'll say third time's a charm, and that's sometimes what it is. Look at those mountains back there, SimFans. How about that? How about those textures? That's beautiful. All right, let's go ahead and turn on our parking brake, and let's get this bird shut down before I kill us. All right, so we got that set. I'm going to turn off the track IR. All right, and I didn't turn on the APU, and that's okay. We'll just go ahead and light that up right now. All right. Whew! I'll tell you what, I think SimFans, I might be sweating a little bit. I might be sweating a little bit. That was tense. See, Aviation Spotter, you got me. I said I was going to make you eat your words, and then I ate mine. That was fun, though, right? I mean, you know, who wants to see perfect landings every time, right? We don't want to see perfect landings. We want to see people screw up. And how did they recover? At least we didn't crash and burn, right? Oh, my goodness. All right, is our APU set up? Is it going? Is it running? It is. It's close. There it goes. All right. All right, SimFans. Well, I'll tell you what. We're going to get this all shut down here. And let's get our APU set, APU gen. And now we can shut off our engines. Whew! Turn off our landing lights. Hey, notice that? Did you see those switch down? I have not noticed that before. Have you guys? Look at that. Look at how they come up from below. I think that's gotta be new. That animation, have you guys ever seen that? That's cool, I just noticed that. Look at that. That's awesome. I have not noticed that. That must be new. I didn't clean it up. I was just like, you know what? I was happy that we landed. And so we're like safe and we're not dead. Appreciate you. So hopefully your butts aren't too sore after that first landing. But let me get caught up here. Don't worry about the center line. Right, Zach. Aviation, you almost did after that go-around. I know. I mean, that was close, buddy. Good night. Go to work tomorrow. Till next time. Frank Rose, thank you for joining us. I appreciate it, as always, my friend. Recon Delta, FAA wants to call you on the phone. Yeah, I suppose. And it wouldn't be a first time, and it won't be a last. Alan says, okay, guys, thanks. Wine glass is empty. All the good-looking flight attendants left 3 hours ago. Thanks, Sim Fanatic, and I will be back. Thank you. Hey, great to see you, Alan. Thank you for chatting. It was great to see you chatting. You mentioned that you were following me for a while. Great to have you in the stream and in the chat, and for sure. Aviation Spotter, can you call the fire department? Good night, you all, Captain Maddie. Thank you all, Sim fans. I do appreciate all of you for joining. I had a lot of fun with all of you. Sorry about the hard landing, but at least, hey, at least, Sim fans, we got the second landing in, and we did it rather smoothly. And if you don't have to leave right away, I'm going to do a few replays. I'm going to do a replay on the first landing that I completely bombed. But then we'll look at the second replay. Well, we'll start with the second because we'll start with the good one. And then we'll start with the other one. Even though I did float that a bit on that second landing, I'll admit that. But again, Sim fans, thank you so much for joining me. Stay tuned this Saturday. Watch for the stream Saturday. I will be doing another live stream at 8:30 Central Standard Time in the evening. And then keep in mind, May 1st, we're going to do a fly-in. We're going to do a multiplayer. We had a lot of fun the first time. We're going to have a lot of fun the second time. If you missed the part in this stream, we did the unboxing of the Honeycomb Airbus Throttle Pack. Do skip back and check that out. I'll be posting something like a little bit higher quality on that later. But again, thank you, Sim fans, for joining me. Take care. And as always, blue skies, stay safe, and we'll see you soon. Stick around. I'm going to do some of the replays. Thanks, Sim fans. We'll see you Saturday.